Match. Good luck, have fun. See how smooth it can go when everyone just cooperates. This is amazing.
Indeed. This is beautiful.
And everyone immediately pulling their buggies to the front lines.
Yeah.
Being like, hello, sir.
Right.
Guys, did you fix your streams?
I did. Seriously, the Edge, you've got the better role here. He's got both a bike and a little buggy.
Yep, so he's gonna be way more mobile and way more aggressive than what Murtuk can be.
Oh, it's going away, so he might do damage.
He might do damage to the power. That is no way.
Oh no, he's going to actually do way more damage to the power.
And this is a refinery. This is a refinery first, by the way.
Oh god, Murko the Rai. Well, Andrew is not attacking right now, so...
Well.
Andrew is being a little bit hesitant.
Andrew shouldn't have been hesitant, honestly.
Sucks.
He should have just been aggressive here.
Yeah, and now he took that buggy from Murko, so he could just go back, but the infantry is back as well. So,
Infantry is decent for defending, you know? So that's one thing they can do.
Yeah.
So he can't be very much aggressive into this blob here. Unless Murtos splits up. In which case, the rocket soldiers can be picked off one by one.
Buggy. This is kind of risky what Murtos is doing right now.
Yep.
Yeah, look at this.
Yeah, that's so risky what Murtos is doing.
Got the recon bike coming after the harvester.
By the recon bike. And recon bikes, mind you, are so mobile. Recon bike! Look, the harvester is already in the yellow.
Oh god.
If he loses the first harvester. This is gonna be devastating. That's an early game victory, I'd say.
Yeah. This goes down.
All the harvester going down here.
The
harvester goes down.
GG.
This is atrocious.
Yeah, sorry guys, this is over.
Yeah. Holy crap.
Yeah. Murko can't come back from this.
Maybe Murko can do something.
No, sorry,
especially with this. because he's got two. He's spamming buggies.
God, yeah, he's going for an all in move here. But the thing is, with all those recon, with all those planes incoming, Angie knows this.
Uh-huh. Right. So this is the best Murtok can do is just get as many units as possible.
Oh, he got a harvester back though.
Yeah, but
somehow,
there's a communication center for Andrew.
For a harvester.
Oh boy,
it's pretty screwed.
But he's so behind here.
He is really far.
Two harvesters and comm center for Andrew. So there are gonna be tanks out in no time.
Yeah.
Oh,
for buggies first.
Yeah.
He's got a strong foothold, I'm guessing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And this Murto, kind of soothing music doesn't fit here.
No, Murto only having one. He has four pieces of infantry. What he should do is definitely try and go for an early barracks and capture the oils, both of them, because they seem to never be captured. That could actually help him out a little bit.
The thing is, though, they're really exposed on this map. You can easily snipe them with just one or two tanks.
Uh-huh.
Oh, and you macroing up because you know he has the upper hand. So it's just going three harvesters. And here goes the recon bike again.
Yeah.
Just taking pot shots at harvesters. Now it's on the Tiberium, so it's gonna die because vehicles are slower when they're on Tiberium. I think it's 50% speed reduction.
Ouch. Yeah.
But what a devastating early game blow. That just goes to show how aggressive Nod can be even from the first second of the game.
Yeah. Nod is ferocious. They are poisonous. Poisonous faction.
Yeah, well, seems that...
First light tank.
Oh, there it is.
Uh-oh.
I think.
It's the bucket.
Yeah, barracks.
Now there are going to be more and more light tanks.
All the thing that Andrew has to do is just play it safe.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
Like, Murko is doing okay holding off, but he never... he's two harvesters behind and he doesn't even now have a communication center, so...
Still no comm center, still no... that's so terrible. Still no tanks for him.
Yeah.
Oh, and the infantry is on the Tiberium. Look at the rocket soldier. Just dying randomly.
Ouch.
To the Tiberium.
Yeah.
Oh, he's calling GG.
Yeah, he's
over. Quick first match right
there. That was a quick first match of the day.
Yeah. One harvester taking off, and that just ended the game.
Good luck and have fun.
Nod versus Nod.
Buggy and Buggy. This time the RNG is in favor of nobody.
Yeah, this time they're having even drops. Yes. So three rocket soldiers. And that is exactly the mistake I made on exactly this map. I moved to the middle to kill the oil derricks so ACM couldn't take them with my infantry. And oh then boy. ACM had heard my sound, my firing sounds through the fog of war, and he had deduced that I had nothing back in my base. He snuck in with a recon bike and killed my harvester, and I had no more money to rebuild.
That was beautiful scout by Gatekeeper. Just get all the way through his base, and the buggy of Amphi is just keep retains in the in the base there.
I like not the dance that, of the of the scout units.
Yep.
Yeah. They're so fast and nimble, but they die so easily. So it's really hard to keep them alive. But if you can, it just looks glorious.
And look at this. Look at the position of the infantry.
Yeah. They're gonna.
Ooh.
Oh.
Nope. Still getting away.
That is guided completely. You just have to
chuck that at home and
outrunning guys with missile launchers. Just imagine that in real life. Driving up to five guys with missile launchers and be like, I can take this.
Only missile launchers. Quick.
Yeah, see now he's actually hunting down the buggy because it has so low health.
Uh-huh. Yep. So they both scouted each other. There is no crazy early infantry all in. Because what you can do is you can sell your con yard after you're getting two barracks. You don't even need eco. You just pump out an endless stream of riflemen and rocket soldiers and kill the enemy.
Yeah.
This is possible in Tiberian Dawn due to multiple building queues.
Yep.
Exactly.
But nothing that's gonna happen
there
likely.
You go. That's look the at the scouting.
Done. First blood has been drawn by Gatekeeper here.
Oh, yep. Okay.
Killing the rifle infantry.
Okay, it's gonna get away barely, and
it's five damage on the conyard. Well, that's something. Don't chase over the Tiberium, by the way. That's what you absolutely want to avoid. Now look at the health bars getting shredded. Well,
yeah, it's
too bad. Not too bad. He pulled out in time. But the longer you stay, the more damage you're gonna take.
Both players pretty much on par with each other with airstrips.
Mm-hmm.
Seems that having vehicles out before infantry is more of a thing in Tiberian Dawn.
Ooh.
And Gatekeeper. Yeah, the scout vehicles are just so potent.
Gatekeeper is producing buggies before the harvester, which
that's his second buggy coming in. He's going for the aggressive move.
Yeah, he's going to push in, and Amphi is actually just building harvesters.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
So
and that's a combat cycle or a recon bike. So he's definitely trying for some early game.
Oh, look at this
stuff here! Double refinery selling one off. That is a smart thing because usually this build would put you into low power. Two Tiberium refineries plus an airstrip. But he immediately sells the other refinery after getting the first, the second up.
And
oh wow! This is
so he doesn't get into low power. So
yeah,
Gatekeeper preventing a doobie pull.
Yeah.
Oh god! Amphi already is on tier one with a barrel, hand of Nod right over there,
and the comm center. And Amphi
is going for the first harvester. It is going to be in some trouble if Gatekeeper decides to push and kite the few units that Amphi has.
There is no defensive structure queued up as well.
Here he goes.
First light tank out though. It's out of position. It's let's see.
Yeah, let's see though.
Let's see. He should snipe the barracks first because that means that no more defensive structures can come up.
And oh god, a fifth harvester from Amphi. This is terrible.
What?
No, after the second light tank.
But he's producing a harvester right now, so he's just going to have these two light tanks. These two are going to have to stop this.
Yep.
That's
pretty crazy early game aggression.
Oh god,
what about
terrible
power situation here? No, he's still fine.
No defensive structure. Oh, and this is
structure. Going for the barracks.
He needs to get the hand of Nod here.
Yeah. Alright. Nice. Nah. No, didn't get it.
Nah.
He's out.
Too risky for him. So he's just sniped the power plant.
He could go in the
kite
though. Yeah, I guess he just wants to pull back and take another shot.
He's trying to move around and get the other power plants because I think he has scouted scouted most of the power plants.
Oh!
Okay. Two-prong.
Oh, bad pathfinding by the buggies. Or maybe they
No, it's a two-prong attack,
This is intentional, definitely.
Yeah, right, buggies going in from the front and the bikes doing the damage from the back lines.
Oh.
I think the plan here.
Probably sniping some harvesters.
But keep in mind, there are no light tanks. Oh shit, Amphi's floating.
Hurry.
Yeah.
Go for the harvesters. Oh, there's the turret.
Amphi is in Doomy mode.
Very nice turret.
Amphi is in Doomy mode here. Yeah. He needs to get at least one. Oh god, he doesn't even get one harvester.
Yeah.
That's horrible. Okay.
That's a bit costly.
Very costly.
A couple more buggies coming out.
If you look at the combat tab, 900 versus 2,900 killed. So Gatekeeper needs to pull off something crazy because he knows he's behind.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, Amphi is floating, but he's
and he's also
here.
Low power. Oh no, finally there it is. He undoomed himself.
Undoomed. Yeah. Actually, the hunter from Rise of Threads was saying earlier that it's funny how quickly you guys caught up with the pulling the doomy thing.
Yeah, but it's mutual because you also picked up on the Allahu Akbar pretty easily, so.
Yep.
All right.
Yeah, but yeah, good point. Pulling a doomy just sounds fun. We always said pulling is so scared, which meant that you lose like 500 more units than the opponent and still win.
Exactly.
So that's I see that Gatekeeper's actually moving his call yard out, probably to the northwest for a bit of an expansion.
But surely. He might have to do this, but the light tanks of Amphi is going to go around and pick off stuff, so it's going to be a little risky, but they might have to do this.
Yep. It all depends on when Amphi is going in the aggressive, because so far he's just been turtling up. Double airstrip now. See, look at all the gun turrets, look at all the defensive. Well, look at how defensive he's playing.
Yeah.
Like how defensively he's playing Doomy.
Uh-huh, I see that.
Yep. The first defensive squad moving out in self-defense.
Yeah.
But no big moves. I think he was waiting on the airstrike. Now the airstrike is up.
Alright. Here it comes.
Let's see if the A10 strafe can be absolutely devastating in this game. Decimating blobs of even tanks.
Absolutely.
Another power plant from Amphi.
Mm-hmm.
That's quite a nice big army that Amphi's got, though.
Yes.
Yeah.
Does Gatekeeper have anything to answer?
Just a couple of buggies.
Yeah, all the light tanks are out of position.
Yes, quite a bit of light tanks, but they have to be pulled all to the left side right now.
Amphi's
going for the expansion. It's going to check the expansion and find it.
Uh-huh.
Oh, that's not an expansion, that is the original conyard.
That is his first conyard indeed. And he doesn't have a repair pad.
He should sell out. At this point, he has to sell out because the conyard won't survive.
You don't need a repair pad. He has the communication center. That's actually the building that unlocks the MCV.
Okay.
Yeah.
So he can't come back from this. But he has to have a good engagement here.
He needs to clear the army.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
If he loses this fight here, then he's out of the game.
Pretty much. The Art of Fire was fire.
The crushes.
That single light tank.
Earning
his veterancy.
Yeah,
10 crushes.
That's going to be it for the army of
look at those hedges, the positioning here. Those hedges here were positioned in such a way that the tanks from Gatekeeper had to take the long way around.
Pretty well defensively played by Amphi here.
Yeah, super defensive. An engineer here for Gatekeeper. He's trying to probably sneak cap something.
Foil Derek, perhaps?
Maybe. At this point, it's a bit late, though. Yeah, he's going for both the oil derricks. Wow.
Well, why not? I guess he needs all the help he can get.
Why not sword bark? Yeah, why not, I guess.
Amphi's coming into the south.
Okay, he's got a cognac back up.
Yeah.
Fortunately, he had the communication center tech.
Gatekeeper indeed going for the oils. Both of them.
Yeah, and he's going for the blue Tiberium. It's a desperation move here.
Yeah.
He knows he's so behind, he needs to do something. But he's going to meet up with 7 light tanks.
Yeah.
That's his second conyard done, and I think he's going to call quits after that.
Yeah, after this it has to be GG.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
No. You can't just lose your conyards left and right.
Flame tanks, though.
Mm-hmm.
But they're cool.
Right.
He had to try for some crazy stuff. He needs to sell out, like, if your conyard is being pummeled, you need to sell out, you won't get away. Yeah.
But he does.
Smart now. And the flame tanks I would rather go in the main base with.
Yeah,
they're good with infantry, they suck with flame tanks.
Yeah, look at the contain. Yeah, it's got complete contain and gatekeeper, so it's just not going to work out.
This has just been a snowball effect and a half.
Uh-huh.
What you can do with the light, the flame tanks, is what he's trying now, is using them as suicide bombers, because they have quite some AoE damage when they explode.
Yeah, unfortunately, it does more damage to himself than his enemy, by the looks of things.
Especially to infantry. It kills off infantry pretty reliably. It's like the China Battlemasters with the nuke upgrade.
Yep.
Airstrike might do something, though. He's got airstrike ready.
If this gets airstriked, then Gatekeeper will probably rage quit.
Oh, they both have airstrikes, actually.
Both have the airstrike up right now.
Is it ready
but now? It's just such a meticulous thing. Do you use the airstrike right now? Do you wait?
Oh, it's ready. Offense.
Conyard back up. He should deploy at his original base this time.
Yeah, definitely. Try to keep it safe. Choice. Play real defensively with it.
That's just what's happening. Look at how many tanks and how many rocket soldiers are moving out here.
Yeah.
Oh god.
Got more tanks coming in from the west.
Getting under fire.
Oh, and airstrike
no,
also there.
No, airstrike the small blob. What a mistake here.
No, actually, it's good because...
Oh.
Got something off of there.
Well, it did something good, yeah. But again, Conyard needs to be sold. And
no,
if the comm center goes
right
down,
side.
It's GG. No, it is
and
GG.
And the other airstrike. Nasty. Wow.
That's it.
Indeed.
No. This is GG indeed.
This is GG. There is no comeback here. Yep.
GG. Right.
For fuck's sake. That was a good game though.
Indeed. Wow.
Yeah.
Not gonna lie, that was a good game indeed.
Yeah. Failed rush by Gatekeeper, which turned into a long haul advantage for Amphi. And who are the players?
Murtyray in the left, with his classic Ukraine pick, because he loves them parabombs, he loves them explosive surprises, and he loves them demo trucks.
Ooh,
and
yes.
He is up against the Germans in the form of Commander Amphi, who is already opting for an early barracks. Murto is going for his classic dog scout again, because he likes to sniff out his opponents.
Yep.
Sniff his opponents' tails.
Exactly.
Tails never fails, guys, remember?
Uh-huh. They should hug the sides of the map, not to get intercepted by infantry, because here...
Yeah.
Ooh.
Ooh. Making a U-turn here.
Okay, all the way to the edge, and he'll...
Jump,
what's going on?
Jump!
Oh. What the hell?
Nice!
Well, that kind of reminded me of my match yesterday against...
Murty with the BM, oh god.
Nice
attack move, bro.
Oh,
yeah, that's what happens when you don't use attack move.
Oh,
let's see if he figures it out this time. Yeah,
and then
it's
over.
Ripped out.
Well, at least he got to see that Amphi is building quite a few infantry to begin with. Quite a few.
Yeah. He's trying to be super safe here.
Yeah, but super safe against Murto. Murto is going in for the long haul.
Exactly.
So,
Murto is not a crazy all-inner.
No.
There.
So let's see though. Let's see what these crazy bastards
look
are.
At this defensive infantry here from Amphi.
Super defensive, I'm liking it. Thing is, you can't out defensive play Murto the Ray. Because he's playing it like a clockwork. Except he's switching it up here and going for a Gren.
Okay. Well, Amphi has the defensive structure, he should take damage, but alright.
Shut up.
One Gren?
That is one Gren in an APC, just to be obnoxious.
Oh,
Gren is
gonna
force a defensive structure here, you know?
Yeah, oh, that's such a good point. It's gonna make
Amphi
waste a... It's gonna make
it's just gonna make him waste money on defense structures
by
dropping off
nice...
one Grenadier. It's pretty funny.
Yeah, it's pretty good. Yeah, and now Amphi's not gonna suspect that there's something in there because it's actually just attacking.
No. Yeah, exactly. If you attack with an APC, you usually don't expect it to be a rush of any sorts.
Ooh,
now the
rocket
soldiers are coming out. Yeah, because he wants to defend against the APC
nice
block.
What? Are you kidding me?
He sold his barracks?
Yeah.
I don't get it. He was on low power, that's why. He was on one power plant.
He was pulling a doobie.
The rocket soldier is down.
The civilians! And the Gren, look at the Gren.
Oop. Oh, you can't! Oh no! Okay, there's lightning. Thank God.
And crushing warrior infantry.
This is doing some significant damage already.
Yeah.
I can feel the comeback here. I can already feel
the
comeback. No, yeah. He's just scouting.
Second light tank, why?
Look at the Gren here! Okay, finally taken out.
Okay.
But look at how much damage it did to the refinery. It put it into yellow.
Ooh. Yeah, but just the harassment alone is completely worth it. Mm-hmm. Amphi is completely on the back foot here.
That was a hilarious move though. Uh-huh. I've never seen the one Gren trick.
Now, Amphi is going to have to camp the aura findings of Murpro if he's going to come back here, because it's looking grim.
Yeah, look at the eco. Just four ore trucks, casually, strolling out and service depot.
Oh.
I think that's an APC coming up for safety. No, another ore truck. Fuck safety.
These light tanks, they should just move right ahead into Murpro's base and try to camp both of the ore refineries.
Exactly, because there is no army yet. Fearful truck. What's the next thing gonna be? Production? Oh, a heavy tank, okay. But a Tesla Murko, coil is 15 seconds shy of coming up.
Yeah, Merton needs to camp one of his ore refineries with his ore truck. At least... Oh, there we go!
Yeah.
Okay, one. Oh, this is so nice! This is nice! Okay, set. No light tank for you. No light tank camping for you.
Yeah, the light tank box is just not gonna happen.
Yeah,
he's
Merton's
just sending
just so
his ore trucks in and out of here.
Yeah, Merton's
so these light tanks are not gonna accomplish anything.
Yeah.
Before they're getting down.
The first heavy tank
down.
Already... This is the Murko we love to see.
Yeah.
Heavy tank build.
There.
Heavy tank build. Haven't seen that in a while. And
for Murko.
Here goes the second tank. Boom.
Yeah. Okay.
Eviscerated.
Yeah.
Are we going to see some sneaky bricky navy transports?
I don't think so.
Sneaky bricky, I don't think so.
Not this game.
Is not required.
It's a 1v1, and you know you can do it in 2v2 too because your teammate can support you on the defense on the ground.
Uh-huh.
And when you go to the sea, but if you do it 1v1, you just have too much stuff invested into the ocean, especially early in mid game, that your opponent can just crush you. And but maybe later though.
There is a Chinook out here for Amphi. Is he trying something fancy here?
He has to.
Chinook du Germain. It's a German Chinook though.
Murko is actually not going for full heavy tanks. He's building an MCV and it's taking up to airfield. So this is
so it's not a Chinook. It's more like a what's the German equivalent? Gazelle. All those Gazelle. German words sound so fucking graceful. I love it.
Gonna try a rocket soldier drop here or?
Yeah, it looks like it's going to try to do some damage against Murto's ore trucks here.
Yeah.
Oh, Murto just looks so solid here.
It just looks so solid. I don't know. Like, it's so hard to break this now. There's an expansion for Murto out. There is a Yak already scouting everything.
Yeah.
And what does Amphi have to his name? He's got, like,
a helipad. He's got a turret.
Yeah.
He's got a defensive turret and a defensive pillbox.
Yeah.
And he's got a couple defensive rocket soldiers in his defensive Chinook.
Uh-huh. Even taking out the spotters, that's very nice actually.
Mm-hmm. And the Chinook has not been scouted yet, but there is so much infantry, the Chinook can already surrender.
Actually,
you're going to Abank.
If he manages to sneak it up north directly, he could actually do some damage, like kill the...
He can pick off one or two harvesters and that's it, because there is so much infantry just scattered about. What Murto always does, he plays so safe. He never leaves his entire army in one place. He always just has like a backup squad somewhere.
Here it comes.
Yeah, I mean, that's a nice move here. Don't get me wrong. It's really nice. Five rocket soldiers can take out an ore truck in 2.5 salvos, I think.
Okay.
Two even.
Let's see. Here we go.
Well, look at the bed,
he's going to get one at least.
There
he's going to get one at least.
One.
That's good.
That definitely
now,
alerted Murto.
A lot of infantry is moving out.
What's this?
Oh, yeah. Very nice move by
Aegon. Got popped. Oh, and the soldiers are running to the Chinook. Are they going to make it? Oui!
Wee-hee!
Wee-hee! Vive le baguette! Vive le baguette! The Chinook
Le croissant!
Le croissant! Je suis croissant!
Wow. Yeah, Murko is not going for the heavy tank because of the map, obviously. This map is if you don't take the chokehold, no matter what your intentions are, you're going to be in a disadvantage. Oh,
this
nice
map is choke point central. Yeah,
picking
off the
scouts. Mm-hmm.
And so many flags. That's a flock of flags.
Wow, okay,
coming
this
in here.
Actually dangerous.
Five flags chasing away the lines.
Yeah.
There is just no dice here, no dice.
A couple of medium dice.
Actually, ironically enough, the only chance for oh god, an A bomb. Yeah.
Already?
Only chance for Amphi would be to move to the waters and lock down the middles by means of destroyers.
Yeah.
That's the only option he's got right now.
Yeah, I have to agree with that. That's I don't see a way to come back. He's building medium tanks, but yeah, look at this.
Indeed, on a map like this, medium tanks don't work because it's a choke pointy map. It is choke point central.
Yeah.
You definitely don't want to go into this.
Oh, is that a second MGV? Yeah.
Woo! Oh, that's not. Oh, it took down the tech center, of course.
Yeah. Tech center. Immediately getting sniped.
Yeah. Second MGV, also for an MV with a defensive AA gun.
Yeah.
By the way, Amphi is floating again.
Is he?
He's floating real hard. You can see by his harvesters just idling.
4.5.
Oh, losing the spotter hind in the front.
Oh.
And here's already an aggressive move out with the blob of Murta.
Yeah, yeah. Very safe move. Oh, it's going to kite. Not much. In the medium tanks here. Probably. Yeah.
Oh god, medium tanks should never be hit by V2s. Always should keep them moving. But there is so much anti armor coming their way.
Yeah, he has to run. So bad. Here comes the Heinz, but they can't do anything.
No, this looks horrible already.
Oh.
The A bomb timer is ticking down and it's gonna make him feel extremely uncomfortable here.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
And this is red alert, so there is no RNG involved. This is just pure.
Ooh,
nice.
There goes the AA gun.
Yeah. Plus, the mobile flags are focusing down the Heinz whenever the Heinz show their face.
Yep. Heavy takes for down for me. Two more Heinz for me. Defensive gun turret and a defensive pillbox.
You need artillery versus this.
Yeah, I did. Huh? Yeah, there it comes. Too late, though.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but still, Heavy can establish himself in the middle.
More Heinz.
But as you said, finances, the clock is ticking.
Yeah.
Yep. 7 minutes and counting.
Also has the iron curtain up. Also has the iron curtain.
We're gonna have new Kype in the chat, guys.
Yeah, iron curtain as well. And it's small insurgency.
Oh, no, look at the hits. Oh. They can be really good. These hits can be really devastating.
Yeah.
Is there Navy on the threat? Well, you can build Navy, but there is none to speak of just yet.
Mm. Yes, it's actually very viable on this map. It's just that the allies get more benefit out of their navy, and Amphi has been so behind that he doesn't really.
What?
Iron curtain coming in.
Oh.
Iron curtain flags make quick work of all
artillery.
Allied damage
dealers.
Goodbye, Heinz. Goodbye, Artis. Was nice knowing you.
Oh, nasty!
Nice knowing you, guys.
Going after the infantry too, or just the defensive
structures?
He is probably a V2 on the rocket soldiers. Yes.
Oh!
Boom!
Ow.
And he didn't lose anything. This engagement was completely free for Murto.
Yeah.
That's the beauty of the curtain.
Oh!
In the middle of Amphi base, I didn't see what he took out. Was it a radar dome?
A power plant.
No,
it was a
power plant. Alright, fine enough.
Radar dome was shut down though.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Prevent pulling a doobie.
There was low power for Amphi.
Ooh, Amphi picking off a refinery there.
Mm-hmm.
Not too impactful.
Nah. Nah, three Heinz, and now it's empty.
Oh,
okay, Murto is now going for subs, and the thing is, even if Amphi doesn't have any navy to speak of, the subs are going to provide line of sight for Murto. And they can't be countered if you don't have navy.
Uh-huh.
Here comes a paradrop, just in the back lines,
down,
just a scout there, sailing down, boom.
Wouldn't
now look
be
at the vision for Murto. Look at this, he can see the artilleries, so he's able to just engage into this. Ooh, it's more and more Heinz getting lost.
Yeah, this is just looking worse and worse for Amphi.
It's looking grim. Looking very grim here. And say, what he needs to do here... What he needs to do here is just force fire with a V2 rocket, because he sees all the four artilleries, he should just move the rocket up. Yes, that's exactly
there you go.
What he's doing.
Oh, look at this!
All the arties! Two! Taking almost four arties in a single shot.
And all that was made possible by him building a single submarine. He even sold the sub pen afterwards. No, he destroyed, sorry.
Uh-huh.
Destroyed by the Heinz.
Still, yeah.
Yeah. This single submarine is gonna be so much, like, it's gonna provide so much worth for him.
Yeah.
So much scouting information.
Ah!
And there goes the last artillery.
Yeah.
Amp is floating again.
For the viewers watching, the artillery will actually have a area damage or surrounding its perimeter.
They have a chance of exploding. The chance is exactly 50%.
Yeah.
So upon death, there's a 50% chance that there's going to be a domino chain reaction that fucks over your artillery.
Yeah, if you line up all spike. If you line up all your artillery, it's going to be hell. It's going to be hell for your let's see.
Anyone else having the lag spike here?
Yeah, me too.
I do.
Murto!
There's a chance.
There we are.
Okay, we're back. No one has disconnected.
Fine. Now look at the infantry blob just behind the tanks. All these
V2s. Here comes the money shot. Beautiful. Yeah. He's just moving in with his iron curtain.
Yeah, I think Murto is saving that infantry blob for later. He just doesn't need to risk anything at this point. He knows that he's just going to win.
At some point, he's going for the breakthrough, but that's not the time yet.
Yeah,
he's just poking away here.
Yep. Go for the middle or no?
3 minutes on the nuke timer.
Oh boy. Cool. GPS satellite is 6 minutes though.
Yeah.
Chronosphere for
oh god. He's trying for an all-in crazy game ender base push on the back lines or something. He needs to do something.
Yeah, the Chronosphere could get into the base of Murto and maybe artillery shoot the tech. But if Murto keeps his Murto doesn't know about the Chronosphere.
Yeah, I think. And he's losing his V2s here.
Oh yeah. And can you actually Chronosphere an MCV?
Ooh.
Plus a couple of flak trucks to boot.
Steve.
Oh, but this is just flak truck porn here. Two flaks, one arty. Popular internet video, two flaks, one arty.
Yep.
Ouch.
Question, can you actually chrono an MCV?
You can. And if you deploy the MCV stays there forever.
Nice.
It doesn't return.
Oh, nice pick up with the Heinz.
Nice. Very nice. But now he's wasting his ammo on the heavy tanks. You shouldn't do that.
Okay, nice. No more. No flaks left for Murto, but...
Yep. You need to rebuild flax here.
So the next goal for Amphi is just take down that missile silo, because that's going to be in game ender.
Yeah. Another MCV for him. Is it going to be deployed, or is it going to be used as a backline chronosphere? MCV, let's see.
Yeah, maybe he's going to try for Davy.
It's probably too late, honestly. Yeah, it would have been a smart strategy, but now there is just so much mass here that it's not the best call anymore. And the tech setter is hard countered by the faction pick of Murto, because Ukrainian paradrop can one-shot a tech center. Against Ukraine, you always go two tech centers. You have the money. And if you don't have the money, you just don't go tech center at all.
Because of the 2v2, I could actually come up with a very brilliant idea for having allies and or one allied country and Ukraine in a single team. Have a second MCV, have a Chronosphere, and have a war factory, a Ukrainian war factory ready with a demo truck, and just plop, 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 boom, done.
Yes, that is a very, very classic and useful strategy. Has seen some play.
Nice. Yes. And now goes the Chinook.
Yeah, Le nothing Chinook. In it.
No!
Has been falling, no!
Come on!
That infantry jumping out of the chopper was just right into the ocean.
Full baguette fromage!
Croissant fromage! No! Look at that!
Alright, 15 seconds for the nuke. This Chronosphere, I don't know sure. Okay, he has a lot of infantry.
He's going for
Arctic. He has a lot of.
I think he's going for the Arctic Chronosphere. I think he's going for the Arctic Chronosphere.
Oh, careful with the straight into the flak fire here. He's
looking for the tech because he doesn't see it. Okay, now he's going to see the tech.
Not yet. Now he's spotted the nuke.
This is the nuke.
Yeah.
This is the nuke.
He's going for RT Chrono.
He needs now.
He needs
right now.
That's exactly what he needs to do. But
now
he Chrono's into Tesla clone range. He's going to be... Okay.
Oh, quickly!
No, that's a good call.
Nice! Iron Curtain on the...
Iron Curtain.
Beautiful.
Okay, at least he's going to get the tech center. Tech center is going to be pretty...
Tech center is
dead. Okay, he's going to spread his artillery. He needs to spread his artillery because if...
He's got all the tech here.
Yeah.
Okay.
So they get back to
it's not going to change the outcome of the game.
No, unfortunately.
Oh, four Audis Chronos back. But a nice move regardless.
Yeah.
Very.
Nuke all the Chronosphere.
against Raider Dome and Chronosphere. Why not?
Tanya for Amphi. Offensive, defensive Tanya here.
Defensive Tanya. Oh yeah.
That's not gonna be a game ender though. That's gonna kill the Raider Dome and the Chronosphere.
And the power plant.
And no more, the helipad. No more artillery. For now.
Yeah. Oh, peril bombs on the. Ooh. There you go.
And there is a single Yak. A single Yak that it can now.
Yeah, nothing to protect those artillery as well.
Second Yak coming in. Just play 52 pickup here. Rattle the
artillery though. Nice.
Go the chain guns. He should shift Q the attacks. Oh, woo! That's better. That's more like it.
There you go.
That was a devastating nuke here.
Now Murko can go for the A move kill if he wants to. He has
everything.
Just one artillery left, and
by the way, one cool trick you can do with Tanya.
Look at that!
You can
shift
her inside a camo pillbox.
You can put it in the pillbox.
And then Tanya won't start shooting until she sees infantry.
And look at this.
Tanya. Nice. She got some good shots. Still,
she was too close.
Yeah.
Well, there's still one artillery left. These flags have to kill off that artillery because that artillery is going to do the damage that it needs to be done.
Unless the flags get all killed.
That's true. Uh-huh.
In which case, oh god, Murto is just A-moving here.
Yeah,
he wasn't micering that.
No, I guess if I thought I could just A-move everything and just wall over. Gatekeeper, no, excuse me, Amphi is, he knows how
Yak-strafe
to at least deal damage.
For the call yards. Mm-hmm. And it's gone.
Yeah. What is with the shipyard for Amphi though?
I don't know.
Oh, Amphi's broke and Murto is floating 12k.
Yeah.
12k! Dang. Yep. Look at that, double sub pen for Murto and the sellout on the shipyard here.
Yeah, he just realized.
Immediately. As soon as he saw it. No, he didn't see them. Just a random sell.
Well, what's going to happen now? The GPS satellite's going to come up in 50 seconds and then the Amphi. Why can't
he ping it?
Gatekeeper.
There has
Amphi's going to see how
Murto
far behind he is.
So Murto probably knows about the tech center. Yep.
Was this para drop or?
Yaks coming in.
Oh,
you know what he did here? The para drop has been tanking for the Yaks.
Nice.
But unfortunately, it's crashing out of the sky.
Yep.
We're going to see a GG from Amphi now.
Yeah.
Any minute, I feel. This is
Amphi's
nothing.
Broke.
Nothing left.
Look at five harvesters. Down bottom right, just sitting there.
Yeah.
Looking pretty.
They're on strike.
Oh!
Ow!
Nice, Allahu Akbar.
Yeah.
That was a really good crash here.
Nice.
A very nice crash. Nice, yeah.
Nice. So, Merton knows he's won, so he's just producing subs out of three sub pens because why the fuck not?
Yeah.
Why not Zoidberg?
Why not the nuke truck?
You should build nuke trucks. Mad tanks, dude. We need mad tanks.
Yeah.
Or what else haven't we seen? Hijackers. We've not seen hijackers in the tournament yet.
I think
or
we did.
Crazy
we
flame
did.
Drops.
Oh yeah, I think we did early on, and they just completely.
It failed.
Well, it might not have been in the tournament. I don't know.
No,
what
that was on my random game. I tried making it work versus frame limiter.
Yeah, that's right. Oh well. All right, Amphi.
And there goes the last party.
Time to call quits. The stakes were too high.
Indeed.
Boom. Chew on this.
Yeah.
A single artillery remaining here. Mm-hmm. Hey, there's the curtain. Hunting for the last artillery. Even with the Yak, suiciding a Yak. Because why not?
Get that artillery. A second artillery coming out. Oh, look at this. Fire into the crowd. Oh.
Yeah, fire into a nice shot and a nice party crasher.
Oh, that could have
artilleries
been
are the best party crashers. Spy plane.
Spy plane.
Diardi.
Take down.
Devastating Allahu Akbar. Unfortunately, friendly.
Wrong.
Okay, take down the artillery already. Oh, power down.
Wait, eight gun out.
Artillery, please kill.
And Amphi calling the GG.
Last Ardy done. GG.
Excellent
nice match.
Game. Yeah.
Amphi's been holding on for a while, but he just fell behind early.
Uh-huh. Trying to send his miners in for the crush.
Yeah, demolition derby.
And it is over.
And it's over it is bomb. Indeed.
Let's actually have to
look at the APM. 62 APM for Merc to the Ray.
Oh.
That's some crazy stuff there.
He has been practicing a lot the past few weeks. So
60
I'm not surprised
is something
to see that.
You can only get with airplay. With basic ground units, you're not gonna make this.
Yeah.
Yeah. Nice
combat.
Game. Let's look at the combat
Indeed.
Tab. Pretty decisive. 1.5 times more units killed for Murto.
Really?
He was just... Yeah, he just had a stranglehold on the game.
In terms of...
Alright. GG.
Indeed.
GG.
And let's do the last one we won.
Battle control terminated.
Let's jump back onto the server. Good luck and have fun.
Indeed, here we go.
I should just show you the replay quickly later on.
Okay.
That was such a hilarious game.
Sure.
Both got a Humvee.
Mm-hmm. Both have the same drop, so it's nothing out of the ordinary.
Brackets!
Yep.
I'm going to remove the brackets, yep.
Both playing as GDI. And yeah,
Round.
Mirror matchup here.
Gatekeeper has his works cut out for him. He's going to, but if he's being let into the mid and late game, then he's going to match up nicely. He's doing very good, nice in Tiberium Dawn for the mid and late game. But the early game, is I think he's got his cut out for him.
Yeah, according to
and he's just so experienced.
Dangerous.
You know, Gatekeeper could have picked off the rocket soldiers here.
Yeah,
if he hadn't taken that much damage from the
I'm looking here at my own chat, and it says the Gatekeeper apparently has a backup player from Tiberian Dawn.
He's a good, don't get me wrong, he's a good TD player.
He's not out of the
it's
game
just that
just
Andrew
yet.
Is probably one of the best.
Yeah.
Andrew's up there with like ACM and AOA General.
Ooh,
taking a lot of damage on the rockets already.
Yeah, on the Tiberium. Not a good idea.
Don't step on the tip, guys.
Yeah.
That's what we learned from this. What have we learned today, kids? Don't step on the tip!
Step on the tip.
There is a certain eco strategy that makes your eco boom on this map, and I just haven't figured it out for the life of me. Played like, I don't know, 15 or 20 matches, and I won a single one because there was a crazy early game all-in. That I won by one health on my FCB.
I can see you!
Some John Cena thing.
I see you.
You can't see me.
There's
Tell
the Rocket Factory for
there.
Both players.
Yep.
They're both going for the Harvester.
This the speed leads me to believe. No. Yeah, double Harvester. But the speed led me to believe that it would be an APC.
It kind of looked fast, but yeah.
And
yeah, he has
barracks.
Right.
It looked kind of fast. Patience is a virtue, so are memes. Oh god. Memes are not a virtue. Memes are a plague that has been unleashed upon this world.
Only if you truly believe.
So, both going for it really. Oh no, that's an APC now. Gatekeeper's APC. Ready, fired up, and ready to go.
I want to believe.
Will we see an infantry drop though? But
maybe.
Because they actually talked about that earlier. Like, you know, if you go APCs, then it has its limits. It's good against light vehicles, but beyond that, they're pretty useless. Oh, more
what
APCs.
Can actually be pretty devastating is Grenadier APCs, because Grenadiers shred buildings. You just drop them off with APCs, like in your opponent's tech, and they wreak havoc there.
Here comes another scout by Gatekeeper.
Yeah,
Gatekeeper
but he hasn't seen the comm center.
He's been chased off.
And the miners are actually blocking each other off with the fact that there's one refinery and three miners.
Yeah.
But three is still okay, kind of.
Double
it's not too
triple
bad.
APC for Gatekeeper here. He's definitely
that
up to
is
something.
Some, that is going
to
be some early game shenanigans. He's probably waiting on the comm center. Let's see the production tab. Probably here in power. Yeah. Comm center. And that's going to be, I think, Grenadiers.
I'm just building an MCV. What the hell?
Just going for the long haul here, huh?
Long haul? He might
it's
be
like,
double.
It's an interesting build because on this map you're expecting early game aggression. It's really open. It's not as choky as it looks.
Oh, you see the...
What the hell? Is Gatekeeper knows about what's coming.
He's been pinging the weapons factory. Maybe he's pinging us, the spectators.
Yeah, he's pinging us. We are the only ones who has the beneficial of his ping. So telling us, Andrew is doing this, and he's going to build whatever that.
How he set up his hotkeys. Maybe he has just set up like the hotkeys for deploy and for
and wait, for what happened?
Ping next
what
to one another.
What happened to Andrew's? Oh, there it is. Never mind. Excuse me. There's the second
one. He's getting the blue tip here.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. So it's not gonna be Grenadiers after all.
Yeah, so these APCs, what are their roles? They just not being used.
Anti-air, anti-light armor. He was maybe expecting a Humvee rush.
Yeah.
They are very good versus Humvees.
Sure. But I mean, he just built them blind though. Like, yeah. Despite scouting.
That's something I tend to do in TD, because in TD I always get rushed, so I just build stuff blindly.
Yeah.
We have the first helipad out. Orcas are gonna be the weapon of choice for Gatekeeper. Right.
Ooh.
Really risky.
Yeah.
Orcas are high risk, high reward. As
yeah,
Rainy likes
like Myrtle earlier. Let's see if it works out this time.
Good, we're back.
Okay.
Medium tanks and Orcas probably.
And just very slow to get hold of that blue terrain. His early MCV expansion is kind of like.
Yeah, it slowed him down a bit. It was slowing down his roll.
There it is.
Now there it is.
Gatekeeper has seen it.
Oh, scouted immediately. Gatekeeper has been really.
I'm glad
really
I made it this far.
Yeah. This might all come down to the team games. This is gonna pan out to be an exciting semi-final.
Actually,
I have to say.
Absolutely. There's a chance that we might actually have to do the extra game as well.
Yep. Good chance, even.
This is exciting. So medium tanks and Orcas build for Gatekeeper. It's looking to grow strong here. Doesn't have the blue Tiberium, but it still looks fine.
Yep.
And let's see.
Orcas are strongest out in the open.
Yeah. Like, and you with the double build queue, of course.
Yep.
Got double infantry production, double build queues.
He's scouting needs everything.
Yep. Double vehicle production now. Got plenty of eco.
Yeah, it's gonna come down to the engagement.
Yep. But I already see Angie outscaling with his build.
Yeah,
he's got two weapons factories, two barracks. He's just amassing stuff here. I don't think he's producing much from the conyards anymore.
Rocket.
Just content.
Ooh. What happened there?
Yeah.
Orcas have been spotted here. That was just a spotter on the.
Yeah.
MRLS.
To switch.
Gatekeeper is building MRLS. Not
that's actually
the best
very
unit
though.
in a direct engagement.
And just might be forced to go over to building APCs, and the MLRS is going to be okay, especially since because with this win,
I don't feel like the MLRS
medium tanks coming in from the north. Orcas trying to do some damage in the south.
Oh,
airstrike!
Nice airstrike. Gatekeeper
has to pull back. Gatekeeper, you have no business here no more.
Not gonna work out.
Oh god.
Does he airstrike? He has his airstrike.
Oh
god. He may be able to counter airstrike this.
Okay.
Airstrike almost up like 10 seconds. He was too early. He should have waited for like 10 seconds.
Uh-huh.
The airstrike would have been up.
Yeah.
And if it would have been up, it could have done a lot more damage than.
He could have actually killed the center, which would have been a good deal.
Mm-hmm. Airstrike going on over there. Nice run.
Just a couple of rifling.
Could be worse. Yeah.
Nice sniping out the orca.
Oh, nice.
He's been sniping out Angie's orca.
Yeah, that's something. But needs
the
infantry now.
I don't see the MRLS having an impact here, and they cost as much as a medium tank.
Yeah, if they can hit the
It's just post firing.
If they can hit the infantry, it's going to be nice. But it still needs more infantry than this.
Yeah.
Bit of area of the dial going on here.
And he goes for the crushes with the APCs.
Squishy.
Yeah, loses a couple of APCs there, but it's
but now he has no answer to the tanks plus rocket soldiers.
He needs to take down the rocket soldiers.
Orca's going for the tanks in the south.
Orca's going for the unprotected tanks. That's a smart move. The MRLs are not like artillery. They don't do great damage versus
infantry.
They take like two or three bursts,
back.
Depending on.
So this my medium tank by Andrew is going to be taken care of.
Yeah.
Wow.
He's going straight for the
center.
That's
he's going to get it.
Tanks are so deadly. Is he going to get it though? No, he's not going to.
Yeah.
He is. Just barely.
Wow.
Yeah. Alright, so no more
unlucky boys.
No more medium tanks for the moment. Mm. For Gatekeeper. For now.
But in the meantime, Andrew has been able to build up even more stuff, you know.
He's his base his base looks
he just has way more eco.
Way more eco. He's got double production on all fronts. Vehicles, infantry, and structures.
Gatekeeper is now up to double production as well, but he needs to get his comm center.
Yeah.
Comm center is ready, he just needs to place it.
Oh, and it seems that
Gatekeeper, it's been ready for 10 seconds, place it.
Yeah. Needs to get that up.
Gatekeeper was moving
your tech back, sir.
Oh, there it is.
Ah, all the
very defensively on the cliff side.
But
and
here's
the Orca.
Immediately being scouted by the Orca.
Well.
Not yet. He doesn't dare move into this.
Yeah, no.
Orca Libra the fights.
Gatekeeper's
Gatekeeper's Orca Micro has been good. He's been on point there. He has not lost a single one offensive. Like, okay, he has lost one to the guard tower, but that can't be avoided.
Yes. If you...
Now, Andrew looks to be like Gatekeeper can't crush Andrew's base, so he's going to have to keep set his mind to the late game here and get those additional MCVs. He's going to need them desperately if he wants to go to the long game here.
What I'm feeling for Andrew would be the advanced comm center.
Yeah.
Oh,
even just for the ion cannon.
Andrew with the Chinook.
He's going for a Chinook. What is
actually
the Chinook doing
here? Moving out the second MCV.
It can't be a commando Chinook. He doesn't have any commandos. Look at how much Andrew is relying on the double barracks, giving him his pocket soldiers.
Yeah.
Doesn't have that many medium tanks actually, but that's a 10 out of 10 rocket soldier Chinook.
Hand of not completed for Gatekeeper. So he actually took the tech
hand
here.
A hand of not?
Oh, temple of not. Excuse me.
We're having Chiga mirror match. I would be surprised.
What? What did I see?
What
did I see?
What game are you watching, Sosuke? Oh my god! The ten rocket soldiers. The Chinook with the 10 rocket soldiers got intercepted by the Orcas. So that's 10 rocket soldiers down and probably a harvest. No. Harvester survives.
So yeah, not Gatekeeper is building the advanced communications.
Advanced comm center. Oh, okay. That makes more sense.
It's only bet now. Oh, he has it.
Mm-hmm.
There it is. Up to
there is
right.
Another blue tip tree now in the claws of Andrew. This is turning out to be quite an eco build.
Can he snipe?
Orcas not gonna happen. No. And Orcas have a long recharge time after their initial burst.
Yeah. But all Orcas are fighting though. Okay, nice. Switching over to the Harvester.
Yeah, but he wasted so much. He should have been more decisive.
Oh, move back those Orcas, no!
There is
no, what are you doing?
It's not worth it. Wow, that lost him like three or four Orcas.
Tower. Four Orcas and damage to
four Orcas,
to low health.
That was horrible.
That was horrible.
Does he have the airstrike? No. So he's in dipshit because, like, with this concave, it's easy to just force the opponent into a choke and kill him all with the airstrike.
Ooh, yeah. Look at this, though. This,
look at the MRLS. Doing great damage here.
Push forward, Gatekeeper. Ah, it's so long.
I'll try to flank it from behind over here.
This is nice
with the
ABCs
as well. Income the Orcas.
But the MRLS has to force fire the army, not the freaking
airstrike. Oh god, that's gonna be.
Oh, nice airstrike there.
Could have been worse. Could have been worse.
I agree. So this is kind of nice for Gatekeeper though, because Andrew, as long as he can push out, and Andrew still
have a look at the north. Have a look at the north. Little sneak attack coming in.
Never fucking mind. There's gonna be an airstrike in 20. Doesn't matter. Let's see. That's gonna be the mining operations on the blue tips stopped.
Okay.
That's the only con you have to get
for two. Indeed.
Yeah.
He moved his initial con.
Okay, that's actually...
And it's down.
He can rebuild, but at what cost?
And the advanced communications there, and focus on it, it's going to be taken down as well.
Oh! Airstrike!
Something.
Danger close airstrike, as you would call it to me.
Danger close airstrike indeed!
Alright.
Okay. He stopped the incursion, and there is still the advanced communication center.
Uh-huh. Yeah. So Gatekeeper just needs to build
nice
double
crushes.
MCVs if he wants to go into the long haul. He can't play against a two MCV deficit.
First mammoth tank rolling out of the factories here.
Yeah, I would rather see an MCV.
I don't understand Angie's lack of tech. He is trying for a second Chinook.
Chinook?
Oh. The Chinook is arriving.
MLS?
Oh god, the MLS, you don't want to be here.
Go back.
Run. No, Orca's coming in. Bit. Saying hide and saying bye.
One MLS down.
He's trying to do the damage he can.
Look at this. Yeah, Angie on triple vehicle production. Triple vehicle production for Angie here.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, it's smart. He knows he can push through eventually now that he's raided the eco of Gatekeeper. Yeah. He's setting back by quite a bit.
Indeed.
Yeah.
And there is no more attack vector of attack for the Orcas because there are rocket soldiers everywhere, advanced scout towers everywhere.
Very defensive play.
Here is another loading with the Chinook.
But it keeps building.
The Chinook is going to have 9 rocket soldiers this time around. Oh god.
Alright.
2 Orcas down to an advanced guard tower.
Oh, he does have the Iron Cannon already. So if you can scout a nice chunk of army, you can do some good damage.
Yep.
And you still have
to build poke the harvesters at
There's
least.
A construction yard for
finally.
Gatekeeper.
I think he should just build one more. He can kill off the army of Anju with an Iron Strike if he feels threatened, so he should feel safe to build a second.
He should kill one of the blobs. There is a nicely lined up blob. You know what? Yeah. The Chinook is being exactly scouted by the one Humvee that is still there from the beginning of the game.
Yeah, you're completely right about that. And no, the Mammoth Tanks of Gatekeeper, like the main counter to that one is the Iron Cannon, and Anju does not have the... Oh,
does he chase? Does
just
he chase?
Built the advanced communication center. Andrew
if
did.
The advanced comm gets sniped, I think that might just spell game over.
Well, Chinook is almost there though. This is gonna be close.
Oh god.
It's in the corner now.
It's in the corner.
He sees it. He sees it.
Oh no.
Oh my goodness.
RIP advanced comm center.
RIP.
Yes, not
pepperonis.
Okay, use the Iron Cannon to kill an infantry.
No!
Oh!
Oh my god, too late.
Just exactly.
Too fucking late. That is such a big snipe. 2,500 for the advanced comm center, and the cooldown has been completely reset.
I don't manage to fire it.
Oh no. Okay, Gatekeeper.
The Chinook is still there.
He had the potential advantage there. It's dropped.
Oh yeah. Ooh, losing his Orcas to a single random rocket soldier.
Okay, this is kind of nice. Oh, careful!
Oh god!
Careful.
No! Orcas. 3 Orcas going down.
Okay, it's not micro-ing well, the Gatekeeper is. With these Orcas, unfortunately.
There goes the Chinook just to taunt him.
2, 3... Wait, 1, 2, 3, 4 Quad... Seriously, quad tank production for IQ.
Yeah.
He's gonna be
he's just waiting on the breakthrough.
Yeah, he's just slowly gaining off on the Gatekeeper. And right now, it doesn't look there's too much to stop him.
Right now,
I mean, what's going to stop? There's 2 huge blobs. Oh, look at all these medium times coming
you,
through the middle.
Oh, god. He's engaging into a rocket, so it's just randomly losing an Orca.
Oh, boy.
Yeah,
it's
this
terrible.
Is terrible. And yeah, second MCV for Gatekeeper now, but it's just too
airstrike. All the middle tanks.
Airstrike.
Not even destroying a single tank here. Maybe one.
Not one tank. You see the husk?
Yeah,
one single tank.
One single tank.
Second tank getting picked off. Third tank for one Orca.
Not worth it at all.
No.
Yeah. Andrew doesn't even need that. I don't know. We can just
look at the second
half
here. Another Orca down.
Yeah.
Gatekeeper down to 4 Orcas.
He can't find an angle on Andrew at the moment.
No. Mm. He's gonna try it again with the MLRSs.
Yeah.
Yeah, but look at the pathetic damage they do.
Yeah.
Yeah.
MRLS are just not great. Artilleries are great. Artilleries do so much damage in TD.
Yeah.
The rocket launcher
has the better range, but they're mainly just to kind of siege bases, not to
to be annoying.
Like,
oh, there.
Yeah, bye bye.
RIP. Even overkilling the husks. Oh. Even the husks are dead.
There
it's
as dead as it can get.
And you're pushing to the north. There's nothing to stop this push.
Yep.
There is.
I mean,
advanced comm center is like not even
rocket soldiers. Guarding
the uplink.
Yeah.
Hmm. Yeah, no.
It's too rough.
Advanced guard tower coming up.
Yeah.
He's gonna lose the Conyard again.
He's gonna have to play defensively now.
Yeah. Super defensively.
Defense,
and same
defense,
time to the south, we have the Mammoth Tanks. Mammoth Tanks are splitting off.
Oh, oh yeah, that's a big mistake here.
Two probes attack here.
Yeah.
The Tusk missiles of the Mammoth tanks are doing such incredible DPS, so...
Yeah.
It's always beautiful to watch.
Mammoth tanks are pretty good, but...
Tusk missiles? That's what they're called?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes, they're called Tusk missiles.
Well, yeah,
because mammoths have tusks, you know?
Yeah.
So it makes sense.
Just look at the map control here. The difference.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, it's so horrific.
Wow, he deterred topside. I was not expecting him to hold topside.
And bottom side as well.
Yeah.
Couple of hundred infantry left.
Mm.
Those mob attacks definitely helped out.
Advanced comm is down again.
Once more.
Why hasn't Anju. Anju still hasn't tech to advanced comm.
No, he has.
He does.
Oh, there he is. Never mind.
Yeah.
Never mind.
So
I was just blind.
Just a matter of time.
Yeah.
Yeah. They look so similar. It's just that the satellite dish on the advanced comm is slightly larger.
Anju also coming out with the mammoth things now.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I mean, Anju, he shouldn't. He should just keep expanding. This is confuses me. Like the time he had like this billion mini tanks, he could just build two harvesters extra and just keep placing those refineries. It's just going to be. Just going to macro this in hell.
Yeah. Honestly, Anju could have closed this out way earlier.
Indeed.
Yeah, absolutely.
I don't know why he's been.
Third MCV or. No, that's not a second MCV.
Second MCV for gate.
Yeah, trying to go for the middle.
No advanced comm again, and look at the ore.
Auto aggressive stance?
No idea.
Not usually, though.
Not usually.
Yeah, they do if you set them to attack move.
Mm-hmm. Well, okay.
Airstrike
on the advanced communications.
There you go.
Scout Hover.
Oh, getting harvester at least.
Did get the harvester. Just picking up another harvester over here.
Yeah, it's kind of funny seeing this. It just feels like this should not be a, this shouldn't be happening. But Anju is, you know, he's got the build order right. He's got everything set for an effective structure of his base, his building. But when it comes to engagements and decisions, not to the top player there. Gatekeeper is a more like a decisive player in that regard. So, but I don't think Gatekeeper is going to have that advantage to make him his win.
No.
But it's going to make him stay in longer because Anju could potentially
So many orcas down. Almost all the orcas down here.
Oh, that's true. Okay. So, like, for example, this. Why did Anju do this, for example, with his medium tanks on the top? There's,
Yeah,
it's like a.
That's a meat grinder.
Yeah.
Just waiting to happen.
I am kind of though.
That's why.
That happened.
Oh, yeah, that's pretty good. But still, though.
Okay, so finally he can push here.
Now he can push in the north.
And the MRLs are just free food.
Yep.
Boom.
Also
they go
try
down
to
in, like,
make a move
from
the south, perhaps. He's definitely doing stuff in the north here.
Mm.
Yeah, should be able to. Just
yeah, he should just a move in the south with his six tanks there.
Yeah, he does it.
Yeah.
Looks
like.
Oh,
take out the airstrike. Factory,
airstrike.
There
nice.
We go. Nice.
This is the decisive.
This is
gonna
be enough.
Yeah.
War factory down. Or weapons factory. Nice.
All the same.
Uh-huh.
You're being racist towards GDI.
I don't care.
Yeah, he's calling it.
And
GG.
He's calling the GG indeed.
He's been holding out quite some long time.
Uh-huh. He delivered a great Tiberium Dawn game for being
absolutely
a Red Alert player. It's pretty good.
What's the KDA?
I don't know.
Let's check the KDA. Oh damn, yeah. Gatekeeper has killed way more because the infantry build. But if you look at the combat tab, Anju has killed more in terms of the actual value. That's the stat that really matters.
Yep.
Yeah.
Because Anju lost cheap infantry, which didn't really matter.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Yeah, but a good game. We've seen a good game here.
Battle control.
So that means there is going to be a 3-1.
Battle control.
There we go.
Good luck and have fun this time for realsies.
Indeed.
Let's check the options again, just to be absolutely sure.
So it's probably going to see the
crits disabled,
dog get dance this time. Pretty sure we're not going to see that.
No.
For Rizzle.
For Rizzle.
So you're going to have to dog v dog again.
Yep, down here we
dog eat dog, guys. And then early quick barracks out for gate AI. I love gate AI and to AI.
Yep.
There should be a Norman AI that just randomly crashes the server and disconnects.
Leaves for soup.
Yeah.
Jesus.
The dog, two dogs for Andrew, just as last time. Murder's not actually bothering to move forward with this dog this time, so he's just going to stay and wait
for the other dogs.
No?
And the other dog of Murder is this time going for Amphi, because he's hoping that Amphi's less prepared.
Well, oh, we've got another dance again! We've got another dance! But in comes the third dog!
A third dog joined the fight!
It got eaten!
Yeah.
Third one. Oh, but now Murtos is moving forward, and...
And this time? Oh,
yeah.
Murtos.
He got a
nice by Murtos. Learning from his mistakes, as you always do.
Guys, you can have some infantry up there.
No attack move.
Okay.
And a defensive camo pillbox from Amphi.
Again, he's just playing it super defensively, you would love that.
Uh-huh. It's so costly.
The dog almost snuck by here.
Yep.
Almost. But Amphi, with the last, he's scripting, you know, with the last line of his script, he got the dog.
Indeed.
Wait, did Amphi lose the engineer? Or he just hasn't built it yet?
Okay. He hasn't built it yet.
Good for him.
He's trying to be absolutely safe here. Now he's coming out with the engineer.
What the fuck is he
doing? Murder is telling Gatekeeper to
Murder is pinging something, but there is nothing.
No, he's spreading, he's asking Gatekeeper to spread out his infantry to protect his areas.
Probably. Uh-huh. He has taken on to kind of tutoring Gatekeeper. His Gatekeeper is not that experienced. I mean, he's a great player, but
he's better at
maybe
at
half a year
than he is. Yeah.
Yeah,
he's better at Red Lurk than Tiberium Dawn, so he's a good one. But yeah, not to the very top.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I'm actually hoping that Art of Fire is gonna take this win.
Me too. Yeah. So we can have our deciding match.
Yeah.
What if they definitely have the big chance here to take it.
Mm-hmm.
I'm pretty sure.
Unless Murtos is just such a safe player.
Unless Andrew and Amphi does something special, put him back. So maybe like by early naval shenanigans, which to the late game. I don't know.
That's viable.
Pretty fucking strong.
And Murtos is someone who just plays it like a clockwork. Murtos plays so super safe, it's so hard to be surprised by him, but it's also hard to surprise him.
Gate with edgy
ranger?
Rangineer. Yeah.
Raging Rangineer.
Going for the hospital probably once again.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Last oil derrick caps for Amphi, and all of the other oils are capped already.
Yeah.
And
one thing that the hospital does, by the way, is it just gives you vision. And also, if someone attacks move through the middle, you're gonna be notified.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
And once again, we've got an edgy APC coming in from Borto.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there's actually a couple of rocket soldiers there, so...
Can be a nice crash.
Going to crush!
Okay,
could be worse.
Crush the rocket
one down, though. So,
crushed
just
one of them, and now he can scoot out.
Yeah.
Maybe go.
Oh, it's pretty worth it, I say.
Oh.
Oh, yeah.
Notifying his ally.
Oh,
the oncoming danger.
Here comes the Edgy Ranger.
Oh, he cancelled the
No, not the War Factory, but he cancelled the Harvester.
Yeah, in the War Factory.
Yeah, so that's a delay of what? 20 seconds maybe. Not too bad.
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh, it's bad if you're playing against Murtos.
Are we
going to
see
I'll tell you that.
A steal?
I know.
Are we going to see a steal here?
Yeah.
Maybe. We're going to see a decap.
Indeed.
Why not?
Let's see.
It's going to put some pressure
Amphi
on...
Amphi has been notified, though, and he's going for one of the
orders. Amphi has the appeal box ready, or a
turret. Nah, and also he's just focused the engineer.
Yeah.
There you go.
Murtos must be busy microing something else.
Oh, Gatekeeper is blocking Amphi's War Factory. It's going to delay the Harvester by quite a bit.
There's a gun turret.
So, wow, Amphi is still on two Harvesters here.
No!
Why? You could have blocked him for a little longer, man.
He should have stayed there, but... But Amphi probably knows that you can force fire husks when they're not on a freaking ore refinery.
Oh yeah, that's true. That's actually true.
So he probably was like, okay, it's not worth it because Amphi will just force fire with the turret.
Oh, yeah, look at this. Yeah. Gates already has 5 spies over there. He's definitely up to something.
Britain. He needs that.
As Britain,
that
spies helicopter. Are dirt cheap. As Britain spies, for those who don't know, as Britain, they cost you 250 a piece. Uh-huh. Mm. So you can just spam them and hope that one gets through.
Both Gatekeeper and Murtro is actually favoring the Raider Dome before the Service Depot this time. So Andrew is going for the heavy tanks. Something like maybe Andrew can actually pull off some quick attack here and do some damage to Murtro. It can actually happen. Look, Murtro is
already scouting over here.
Yep.
Jesus.
Hey, okay, see.
Here come the spies. Now he's gonna get a nice disguise here, probably.
He's trying to best push
over
there.
Oh god.
Just this is too bad.
MCV.
This is bad.
The MCV is going down.
Oh, this is horrible.
MCV? Now you get a free disguise. Nice. I got a free disguise on the spies off.
Oh wow.
That was perfect for Gatekeeper.
Yeah. Terrible loss for Murphy. Set back so heavily.
You did miss a bit, CCCT, because this is the 2v2 of the last semi-finals. However, it could very well be, since the score currently is 3-1, that if the Art of Fire here on the right takes this victory, gets 2 points, we will have another match going on.
Exactly. So, CCCP, you missed quite a bit. We've had an absolutely fluent tourney start this time around.
Yep.
No fucking around. Every player showed up on time. It was beautiful.
Minus Spy doing a bit of trolling.
Yeah, except for that. That set us back like 5 minutes. Not that bad.
Yeah.
It's alright. We're having the spies marching in one by one. And if Amphi just doesn't pay attention for 10 seconds, he's going to lose something. He's probably going to lose some cash.
Yep, definitely going to go for it.
Or is he going for better cash?
Oh, 2,800.
Wow.
Nice.
Oh, Murtro probably will, let's see, snipe the ore refinery here. Oh, it's being almost scouted by the Yak, but barely.
Murtro's going mass airfields here, by the way.
Oh, it's going to lose
from the looks of things. Oh, no, the decap on the hospital. What error will Murtro do? Just kill the engineer. Cha! It worked. It fucking worked.
Yeah.
Alright, Andrew just keeps building up his army and it's looking quite dangerous though. But Murtro is only building the tech center, for it doesn't really build anything else of his defensive type, so it's going to forego for the Tesla units. First the
Tesla
tank.
Yeah, he's always banking on the late game. First Tesla tank coming out of facts here.
Murtro is just sniping the refinery of Andrew. It's going to set him not too much behind, but a little bit.
Didn't do much. You know, now he's going for a strafe on the engineer. Whatever.
Yeah.
There is a huge blob coming in. So let's see if Murtro can defend this.
This is okay, and
Tesla tanks.
This is Andrew's time. He's going. He needs to do damage to Murtro here.
Yeah. We've got a Tesla tank in the back though. Maybe he has to do something.
If he keeps it alive, he's going to do the damage.
Well,
Tesla tanks are fantastic, but there is just one of them now.
Okay, Andrew needs to move in the heavy tank, and now the entire block. Oh, could also get a nice Yak crash here as well. Okay, Murtro doesn't.
Murtro pulling back. Nice. He's kiting.
Yeah.
He's kiting the blob. The tank lost without losses on his side.
Why is Andrew waiting?
Oh.
Is he gonna try the Alani Yak car?
Yeah. We might.
No.
Yes. Huh? Retarget. Reface.
Yes. Okay. Boom.
Alani Yak car.
Just a little bit though.
Little bit. We've got a second Yak on standby though.
Yeah.
He's repairing the Tesla tank, so Murtro's good micro. He's just his unit preservation is good.
Yeah.
Well, Eagle's Gatekeeper with a whole bunch of light tanks.
Yeah, that's a lot of light tanks.
I don't know about the light tanks.
Now
not
just
for crushes.
Yeah. Mostly for intimidation and just being annoying. So
asserting dominance. It's like sending out a swarm of 20 mosquitoes. They're not gonna kill you, right? 20 mosquitoes are not gonna kill you, but they suck your blood dry and they're annoying.
They can kill off tech units, but as long as they have map control. I'm not sure what he actually planned to do with the light tanks.
Okay,
but,
next Allahu Akbar.
Yeah.
Is it coming?
He's looking for it, he's looking for the angle.
Looking for it.
Yep.
Oh, it might find it this time though.
Yeah, it is comes! And Allahu Akbar! Boom!
Nice!
Allahu
Akbar!
That was good.
beautiful.
Such a fun minigame. By the way, for those of you who don't know how to counter this, just press the X key to scatter your units.
Okay, that's a light tank push here. It's going to actually pick off the radar dome. I'm pretty sure it's going to go for the attack.
No, he's going for the
harvesters.
Yeah.
That's the tower right over there.
Well, taking a while.
Coil ready.
It's going to put shoes in motion.
Yeah,
see,
one Tesla coil gets picked up fairly easily.
Tesla coil is going down for sure.
Yeah, won't go down indeed.
I mean,
going for the harvester next?
Whatever you expect.
Well, this actually, what is it? 4, 8, 12, so it's like 15 light tanks in this attack.
Look, it's like if you hurl enough paper planes onto a rock, the rock is eventually gonna crumble. It's the same with light tanks.
But it did the damage though. It did the damage. Yeah. He actually took out two
harvesters. Oh my god, that crashes. Oh shit, he's getting the MCV here.
Wow.
What the hell?
Nice. Yeah.
Why did he undeploy? I don't get why MP undeployed here.
Panic, I guess.
Oh. That was a big
mistake.
He got
the two Yaks.
Two
Yaks take good damage here.
Yeah,
Murtrus. Anything does good damage versus light tanks.
And you just have one refinery left after the Murtrus just sniped the second refinery as well.
Yeah, no, that's
Andrew's
refineries.
Too slow to help his. What?
Sorry, you're talking about Andrew, yeah.
Andrew? So he's.
Andrew's
trying to help his teammate as well, but it's just too late and. Mm. Yeah. Being picked apart. Look at the
That is looking bleak already.
Yeah, look at that.
Look
at Murtrus. Massive infantry block coming in.
A lag spike.
Infantry block coming in from the east over here.
Basically, 1 minute on the Iron Curtain timer, and then the Iron Curtain Tesla tanks are just gonna wreck shit.
Right. Well, see you later, Vasily. We will be back at 8 o'clock our time, 7 o'clock GMT.
7 GMT.
Yeah. Actually, daylight. I just received word that daylight saving has already started in the States.
That's not in our control, though.
No, true.
We can't control America.
No, like, GMT is something that everyone can adjust to, even if you're having daylight savings time. Or UTC, for that matter. Because right now, UTC equals GMT.
Indeed.
Yeah. So. What? Andrew is panic attacking into gatekeeper. He knows he needs to get something done.
Yeah,
and,
he's scouting.
Oh,
he's scouting the
block
of
Murtrus. No.
Ah, oh, yes. That's going to cost
now
him
that he's
dearly.
Yeah.
That
now
was also really nice. The explosive barrels, picking off the explosive barrels with the Yaks.
Uh huh.
Yeah.
That was fantastic, actually. Yeah, they know they need to make something happen on gatekeeper. Otherwise, they're just going to get pushed out of the game by Murtrus.
Yeah.
It's a desperation move, I feel.
Yeah.
Are we having a frame show?
Yes. Artie over here.
We're getting
back.
Frame limited. Hello, Yakbar.
Yakbar?
Not great, not great. They heli there.
In
Getty
space.
Heli? Too far. Bit too far.
That still got a lot of them.
I had a crash.
Oh no.
It's okay, you continue. I watch from Doomhammer stream.
You can stream. Hey, Fabius, you can stream screen capture and watch Doomhammer's stream for now to salvage the stream.
That was weird. I had a random crash. Okay. Let me check on Twitch.
So, yeah. I can just tell you what's going on. So,
what the hell? I'm having some general. Can you hear me, guys? Because I'm having some general issues here.
We can hear you fine.
Okay.
What's going on over here, though?
Andrew's attack is kind of dying. Trying to take out the service depot of Gate. Might barely not get it.
Nope.
That's it for the army of Andrew.
This. Look at this. Amphi pulling a doobie at low power.
He's struggling. He just built the tech center.
Yep.
And tech center takes 200 freaking power, so you have to. You have to prepare with the advanced power plant.
Yeah, picking off some infantry down here.
Yeah.
I guess that. Got some Yaks over here. We've got probably a very decisive push coming in here from Morto.
Yeah. Does he
and
have the Iron Curtain ready? Yeah, he does. Oh, look at this. He's going to position his Tesla tanks and.
I'm a bit behind on the stream now.
Yeah.
Oh, you're behind the stream.
Wait, can you guys see? Oh, you can see the ad. Fantastic.
There you go.
No,
the miner down.
Oh, Nuke took the Andrew. He actually take out the entire army of Murtrus. He's going to.
Is he gonna try it? He is.
Look at this. I want to see it.
Oh, sorry, Favis. I'm sorry, Favis viewers.
Well, we will see it on the stream later on.
Come on!
Oh, it's too slow. It's going to go into.
Oh, there's the nuke track. I see it.
Oh, Merton knows about this.
Oh, he still got everything except one Tesla tank and a flag truck. Oh, there's another one.
Hold fire! Hold fire! It's like, please no, hold fire. What he's trying to do probably is pull him into. Oh, wow. Yeah.
Stop the attack.
Wow!
He should have pulled the nuke truck deeper into Andrew's territory.
Yeah.
It would damage Andrew even more.
That completely neutralizes Mirko's army.
In the meantime, what happened in the north was that Amphi was trying to base push towards Gatekeeper's base. Except that got denied as well. We've got a whole bunch of
Gatekeeper has tanked up to longbows. I see a couple of longbows out there.
Yeah.
So, I don't know, the longbows versus Amphi could be good because he's relying on Hinds very much.
SecTV, thank you so much for the follow!
We're seeing Tanya, by the way.
Tanya.
From Gatekeeper.
Oh.
Sonya.
Oh.
Tanya. Sonya, yes.
Tanya.
We're seeing Sonya for Gatekeeper.
Sonya, bloody. What?
Yeah. I just hope that Gatekeeper is going to try to play it safe because they do have a huge tech lead. And, they will, of course, take that into the late game.
It is still lagging it, though, right?
Yeah, it's laggy.
Weird.
Everything is laggy. There you go. The bot is picked it up now. As soon as you hear... this? What? Shock troopers! A rifle in
shock is obviously. Eventually this match is just... Oh god damn, I wanna see it.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, there are the shock piece.
Going after
eventually
the oil
this match is just gonna boil down to the double nukes for a team Art of Fire.
Yeah, definitely.
Like, what can you do?
Oh.
Because, yeah, there are Yaks for Angie, you could go for the tech snipe. But only if the Iron Curtain isn't up.
That's the last of the Shock Troopers.
Yeah.
That's that.
Curtain is almost ready again.
Gatekeeper lost Tanya there. Okay, so I think... Yeah. The tech center of Amphi is the only advantage they have, and Gatekeeper should just focus it down and just neutralize it. The only thing that could salvage this situation for the left side, which I don't see happening, but...
Oh, the thing is, the tech center is really undefended.
Yeah, it looks so disposed.
Both
another
tech centers,
another
actually.
Panel. Yeah.
Both for Amphi and for Gatekeeper.
Gatekeeper should take advantage, or Murder, of the middle ore there, between them.
There are a couple untapped ore patches in this. You see the leftermost ore patch for Amphi, barely touched.
Yeah, he's going
the
for it.
The bottom right ore patch for Anju, almost untouched.
No, actually it is touched, it's just refilling again.
Yeah, it's just, it has two little harvesters. Oh, Gate is experiencing connection problems, I see.
Yeah.
But the late game Tesla army is so dangerous.
Oh. Hey, nice. Keep that longbow alive. The longbow is so valuable.
Yeah, it can deny the vision. And also, for those who don't know, longbows have the largest sight radius together with MIGs in the game. Uh-huh. Both of them have 14 cells of vision radius, which is amazing.
Well, Tanya Chinook.
Both
there.
Le Chinook du Tanya.
There is a power drop on the southern the expansion of Myrtle to the south middle, but it's not going to hit. It's going
to hit the barracks and a couple of Tesla tanks.
Yeah.
The expansion is under
infantry
attack.
As well.
Oui.
Nope. Infantry
that
was
works.
Missed
nice.
By just a single
Gate
tile.
Picking off the Gate chest picking off the rocket soldiers here, and here we see the power drop coming in, which you already have seen.
Yeah.
See? Ooh. So, harvester, two Tesla tanks, pretty good.
Yeah.
Could have been worse, but not much worse.
Yeah. Oh, Gatekeeper is
looking
for that.
Le is coming in.
Yep, we've
it
got...
It also is flanking with 5 mediums.
You know what? Gatekeeper and probably Myrtle is looking for Amphi's tech center. That's why these 5 medium tanks are here. Just, well, they're actually focused on the harvesters. So. But they know
they
about
can just
the
run
GPS
in and focus
line.
The halves.
Yeah.
Look, there is a longbow out. The longbow is here for Gatekeeper. So he has vision on what's happening.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, we could get so many air units here with the longbow.
Go again.
Yeah.
He's oh, what the hell was that? That was a beautiful crash by Murto. You see that?
Toyashi Duke, go for the oil, Derex.
Yeah, going for the oils, but there is... I understand he was trying to pull the Yaks away with his
Tanya!
Five tanks.
Okay, I didn't see her. Oh, took down two of them.
And I guess that was SecTV.
Yeah. Oh, nice.
And there goes, goes the second Derek.
Yeah.
God damn it. Yeah, we will be back in standard mode after this game.
Well, given that we will have another game after this.
Andrew is moving towards that Tesla blob of the Murto. This is not a good idea. Not a good idea at all. And notice that the Murto doesn't even care about building rocket soldiers. So there's no fear of a Yak crash into that blob. There's no danger.
Wow, this blob here. It's pretty deadly. Yeah, that's what you do as Soviets. You against Soviets, you just don't mix in anti-air.
Yeah.
Because then you let the Yaks play 52 pickup. Instead of having them crash into your blob and killing everything.
Yes, sorry, Bob. And you know what? Gatekeeper just had his GPS satellite launched, so Gatekeeper and Murto can see the entire map, every unit, every tank, and so... Oh! We have an Iron Curtain to the south. Excuse me.
You know what would also work? Iron Curtain APCs for a tech snipe.
We've got Iron Curtain.
So many spies out for Gate. Gate has five spies here. And two longbows, and he's been pretty good at maintaining them.
Yeah.
Not getting him killed.
Yeah, and definitely now with the GPS life, I think you can actually see the Heinz coming around the sides.
What was with that? With those flags, though? They were just scouting.
Oh, they took down some Yaks, and at least one Yak, and
I don't know. Yeah. Hashtag just scouting.
Yeah.
Seems that Toya was killed eventually. We've got a power drop behind the two oil derricks coming in at Andrew's place.
That might take down one oil derrick.
Couple of Hides scouting over here.
Yeah, look how...
Oh, they're gonna say hi to this shock division here.
Nice. Try to kill off as many as possible here.
We're having rubber shoes in motion here. Yeah, no enter. If I were a gatekeeper, if I were a Murto, I would mix in more flak trucks.
Yeah, Murto's paratrop infantry. Probably go for the oil snipe. There you go. Yaks moving in.
To the north! Gatekeeper spy is going to try to take down the power, but it's just being scouted by behind. That could actually be a prelude for an attack, but it wasn't working.
MP has been pretty on the ball about sniping those spies. Because keep in mind, you have to focus fire each single one of them individually. You can't attack moving to spies.
Nah, another
it's
spy.
It's pretty difficult.
Another spy from the south trying to get, let's see, probably the war factory here. It looks like he's going to get it because Amphi's mind is somewhere else. Yep. There you go.
If I open the window in full screen, you're probably not going to be able to see much. Let's see. Because then
what
I have to.
What is this guy going to do?
Properties.
Andrew has a drop in Gatekeeper's base. They should be able to respond, but it's not happening. A-bomb there. Yeah. It looks like it's going to be close.
Only six. Beautiful save there.
Yeah.
Beautiful save with only two seconds left on the A-bomb.
Yeah.
And it's ready.
The hell?
Beautiful save.
Well, that was actually, let's see now. They had one A-bomb there. Where's the other A-bomb? That was actually Merkel's save.
What the fuck is going on here?
Oh, I don't speak. Okay, nuke launch. To the top there, we have a nuke launch.
Okay, brackets.
Murto actually thought he was going to do it on the army, but it's going to kill off the tech center of Amphi, which is 19 seconds left for launching the GPS satellite.
Oh, such a shame.
God.
Such a shame.
Yeah.
Position size.
And low
to
power.
Screen. What the hell?
What's going on, 5SS?
Having some issues.
Oh, man.
Reset size. No, it doesn't work. Position size. Hit the screen. Why doesn't fit the screen work? What the fuck? Okay, properties.
Lots of hands going down.
So we do the entire window. What the? Why do I just have the corners? Why?
Check your stream client. See if you can edit the scene.
Yeah, I'm trying to. But okay. It's just not working.
Window capture? Monitor capture?
Yeah. Monitor capture should be it, right? You should be able to add another.
No, monitor capture.
Tab.
What?
Oh. How
would that work?
Oh, what's going on?
I can't extend that fucking window. Don't get it.
Okay.
God damn it, I'm missing so much here.
Okay, let's just tell you what happened. So,
hey Luna, how you doing?
Why can't I extend this fucking
act,
window?
Suicide act into the A-bomb there.
Yeah. Oh, and we've got a massive push out for here in the north from the gatekeeper here.
Yeah. And look at Murko's army as well to the south, Doomy. Look at the freaking blob of Tesla troopers. Like, once that gets in, Andrew either has to just wait for this blob or help out Amphi. Either decision is going to be deadly for him. He can't do anything, he can't move out of his base. He just has to watch his teammate getting crushed by this push by Gatekeeper. And Gatekeeper gets an iron curtain.
Low power! Chronosphere deactivated.
Why? What the fuck is happening?
Oh man, 5 S's.
Like, this is bugging out hard here. I'm just trying to get a part of the screen that was what I used earlier for the brackets. I was just using. And it just doesn't work. I can't reset it. Select sub-region.
And we've got the conflict here in the south.
Oh god, they just obliterated Andrew's force in like 5 seconds. And now continue.
I think here comes the Duke! Oh!
It's such a walkover. But hey, no,
God.
This is... GG.
This is just off.
Indeed, this is GG.
What's GG called?
Yes. Gatekeeper and Borzo.
Nothing is working at the moment.
Remain in the
what the
bracket.
Fuck.
It's 3-3. Wait. 3-3?
Yeah.
It's 3-3.
Why are the brackets now showing the chat? I don't understand. I'm sorry, guys. Like, my OBS is bugging out so hard right now.
Try to.
Wow. Good luck and have fun, everyone. Let me dance commands.
North versus south.
Right off the bat, in a 2v2, with so many early game starting units, you can pull off a lot of shenanigans.
Not only that, we have a 2 GDI versus 2 Nods.
Oh boy.
Ah, the true matchup.
Yeah.
The one true matchup.
Yes.
Brackets be gone. There we go.
Oh,
coin!
No.
Coin!
NPC's
coin!
Coin!
No,
damage
coin.
Early on.
There is no coin.
Oh, so it's the same with the recon bike.
Yep. B1 with coiny.
5 brackets.
Amphi is base walking to the north. I'm not sure I agree with that. It could.
There are 3 tin patches, so.
Yeah.
I don't know about taking the one in the front because it's most exposed.
Not too.
By the way, what is up with the small tip patches here?
So all tip patches. It's just so you have a gated eco. But yeah, this is a very low eco map, all things considered.
Yeah. Yeah, it's no expansions here. So this base is the only one you're going to see.
Yeah, and this is a 4-player map that has less Tiberium than the 1-player map than the 2-player map deterring democracy.
Yeah. Which actually
so
make
gonna
mistakes
see.
Way more
punishing
for the players.
See over here. Any
mistake is going to be punishing here. Because if you fall behind on the economical 8-ball, if you lose too many units, you can't rebuild. Flanking
nice
pincer maneuver on the APC of Murto.
Is in trouble.
Nah, it can outrun the missiles. It should be fine.
Yep, there you go. The combat
took a bit of poke here.
Combat bike not taking any chances.
Mm.
Very defensive barracks here by Borto.
Yeah,
super defensive.
All the way to back.
Sure would. Yeah.
Super defensive here. If he's going with a second refinery, then perhaps.
Well, if he's going to rush, then yeah, he could do that. But mm-hmm. unexpected. Ooh, gatekeeper in
Gate
deep with his hammer.
Oh,
he's going
gonna run straight into the recon bike.
Oh, yes.
Nice. One for one. Good trade because a Humvee is cheaper than a recon bike. They're also less dangerous, usually.
Yes. Nice pick up there.
The airstrip already out for both Nords.
Yep.
Weapons Factory is coming online for the GDIs right now.
Indeed.
Right here, right now.
Right here, right meow.
Right meow.
There's a research for barracks.
You know what? You know what this could be? With all the barracks, both going barracks, both going weapons factory, this might be a drop, combat drop of some sorts.
Could be.
Now, okay, both going for harvesters.
Yeah.
I'd actually love to see a combat drop.
There's little incentive to actually build harvester there because each harvester needs a Tiberium refinery, and the Tiberium patches don't support much more than one harvester per patch.
Yep.
Uh-huh. That's kind of interesting. But always, everyone is building a harvester, so.
Yeah. Andrew is setting up shop here.
Okay, this is actually just. But it does have the defensive. It does have the defensive structure ready, so it should be fine.
Yeah.
This might get dicey.
So defensive.
Did you ever see an offensive structure? Huh? Oh. The only thing we've seen was an offensive nuke one time by Amhole.
Yeah.
So
he placed his nuke silo right in the face of his opponent, which was pretty hilarious.
Yeah. Okay, here comes the attack.
Harvesters take so much damage from this.
Gotta place that. Okay, there you go. Focusing down the.
Yeah, he goes to guard tower.
Yeah.
Oh, but you can kill a guard tower off early on.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, we'll probably
have. Tower is not that strong on their own.
Yeah.
There it goes.
Oh, wow. Down.
Yeah.
But they're fairly cheap. It's whatever.
Uh-huh.
Ooh, and the recon bike bites the dust as well. So all in all, I'd say that the GDI team, Murto AI, and Gatekeeper came out ahead.
Yeah.
In this trade, slightly, if ever so slightly.
Second refinery over there, and all this actually. Posing a funny question here on your stream, Five Aces. When are we going to see offensive Tiberium silos?
I'm all in, okay. After this, we play Tiberian Dawn, we're going to play offensive silo mode.
Yeah.
Communication center by MV already.
One time. When I was playing a game with DN, and we were so ahead that we actually walled off the enemy with silos. We would
have
a wall of silos that no one could pass.
I'm kind of worried about Andrew because, yeah, he built those early units that didn't help him, and he still hasn't basewalked up to the next ore patch. He has one ore patch and has to do long distance mine with his other harvester.
Yeah, his eco is looking not too hot here.
Yeah, kind of worried.
You know what? Maybe they picked this map for strategic reasons because we know that Andrew is someone who likes to go go aggressive and then expand his eco advantage, right?
Yes.
He always builds harvesters on the back of his attacks. So maybe they just were like, okay, in this map, the economy is absolutely gated. Let's pick this map so Andrew doesn't get to do his base creep.
Yeah, very good point. There's the communication center for Gatekeeper.
Mm-hmm.
And
he's actually the first to get. No. The first was
Amphi. Has one.
Amphi has rushed it.
Amphi, Gatekeeper gets this, or Murder gets the scout, actually. It's
Gatekeeper
nice
gets
scout.
A whiff here.
Yeah.
Light tanks. Ooh, three light tanks already for Amphi. Actually, surprisingly enough, I like Amphi's build the most right now.
Yeah.
It's the most aggressive defensively.
Right mm-hmm. Yeah, you can be so defensive with your light tanks. There is a comm center that just started popping here. Ooh.
Yeah.
He could have
beautiful
gotten
scout
bike.
By Murto. He's good to see both bases, you know exactly what they have. So, but yeah, as you said, the light tanks of Amphi actually looks
APC right drops out some
look at the
infantry.
APC. The APC was having 5 rocket soldiers, and those rocket soldiers are gonna poke at the harvester if he tries to mine from here.
And it's actually
interesting
to...
strats.
Oh, and he's getting it in!
He's
look
blocking it off so it can't be crushed.
Oh, nice!
So smart.
Beautiful. Very, very defensively played here by Borto.
Okay,
that is amazing, actually.
Is that
one harvester is gonna fall here, surely.
Gate. Yeah, here comes the infantry.
making a stand.
Just,
and now it's loading in.
Nice! Nice, nice microwing.
Dude. Esmer coming right off the Valkyrie's
front line. Alright. Okay, now they have to account for the light tanks. If they can hold off these light tanks, then they should be fine. But this looks kind of dangerous.
Ooh,
to be honest.
Ooh.
Murder is helping in with its medium tanks, though.
Yep. One more light tank bites the dust. That was a beautiful move, picking off the harvester. And
that was wonderful.
Oh,
yeah.
But there is a Viscerite here.
Viscerite? Where?
It's being killed off right now on the left side. There it goes.
Oh, it got killed off. So, for those who've never seen TD, Viscerite, like, when an infantry dies on Tiberium, it has a 50% chance of becoming a Viscerite. Maybe the chance is lower, don't quote me on that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But that was beautiful play, and now Gatekeeper is coming with the Orca Micro.
Yeah, he's got to be careful because there's four of these beautiful bikes.
Recon bikes.
You can pick them off. Yeah.
Nice, this goes both ways. Recon bikes versus orcas is a matchup that goes both ways.
Pull back the damaged orca. Pull. And
no more anti-air here. Doesn't have any anti-air here.
Pretty
laggy though. I really like the play. I really like the play that has been made.
Shouldn't be able to save the harvester, but he should.
He is. Perfectly fine.
Wow.
What a play.
Okay. Another
gatekeeper holding it down.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, nice. They know about light tanks to find you. That's the only threat right now, and it's being spotted.
Oh, it's so laggy right now.
Oh, airstrike. Top of some infantry, but meh.
Nah, he's moving out of the way.
Yeah.
So he's getting one single rifle guy taking the brunt. No two.
Might take that.
That's what's happening.
No.
That was a wasted airstrike and a half.
Yeah.
There is a APC from Murto. It has 5 rocket soldiers as well.
Yeah, Murto and Gatekeeper looking strong.
Yep. Grenadiers.
Ooh.
What?
Grenade drop right there.
Grenade drop.
Oh.
This is actually now that's the. Wow.
Andrew needs to crush. He needs to crush right now.
Yeah, but they're scattered. This ref is gone.
Oh, nice. Yeah. One more. Should be fine if you can just take
it out. He needs one more. He needs to line it up perfectly here.
Yeah.
Jack. There we go.
Oh,
but nice attempt regardless.
Gatekeeper's orca is still on the left side. He's trying to pick up a harvester. Defensive structures up for your Andrew or.
Look at where a gatekeeper's communication center is. You can't kite into the ditch. So that's a really good place for hiding a comm center.
Very defensively.
The tanks can't fire. Yeah, so defensively. So, okay. Gatekeeper has definitely played this map before. And he knows some tricks on this map that other players wouldn't be able to spot at first glance.
Probably. That's why he chose this map, probably.
Yeah.
And he was the only one of us who had it.
Definitely. Yeah. That was exactly why I did that.
Wow.
Right off the Valkyrie is still going strong here.
Apache's chasing out the Orca.
Apache's
might pick up
so
one.
Good versus
Apache's. Ooh. Apache longbows.
Nice pickoff.
Couple of medium
tanks with
APC over here from Murto.
Game is stuttering a bit.
Yep. Rocket launchers, MRLS is for Gatekeeper.
Yep. I'm not sure about the MRLSs. Yeah, it might be Murto. It's okay. We can continue. If it doesn't get any worse than this, we're gonna have a slow match, but we can continue regardless.
Yes. Let's see who builds the advanced communication center.
All right, and after this match, I will be handing out a bit of a bonus prize to Mr. Strelkov, who has been filling in for 3 matchups in total.
Mm-hmm.
That's right.
Yeah.
Mr. Strelkov.
That's nice.
So he deserves something. He deserves something.
Yep. Actually, has no one produced an advanced comm yet? Oh, there is one coming up for Murto.
Oh,
that's the right call.
Yeah. And Apaches don't do that much damage against harvesters, so he's just going to be meh. Let's kill off this infantry instead.
Murto's Orca just flying into the SAM site to say hello.
Oh,
he just came to
just
say hello.
Ammo, so they should be able to pick off at least one.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay. This is nice. For Gatekeeper,
it's nice for Gatekeeper because he He killed two longbows, and longbows cost the same as orcas, but they have different roles. They're infantry killers, they're tankier, and they're better at anti-air.
Yeah.
Where orcas are tank and building killers.
Okay, Andrew just started on the temple now there.
There's the SOS comms.
That's the late tech. Yeah.
Can you keep stuttering?
Oh, they're looking for a place to put their
airstrike.
And
if this comes in right from the edge of the map, then it's just gonna be, you know.
Oh, look at them! They're trying to stop this light tank from scouting, and it doesn't get to see the position.
Oh, airstrike is coming though.
Yeah, two defensive structures.
Yeah,
not the worst.
Could have been better.
So, Team North has both their airstrikes up, and Team South is on has theirs on cooldown.
Yeah. They could try to snipe the communications
here comes the airstrike.
Oh, not too bad.
That's
not
gonna
too
be
bad.
Better. That's gonna be better. Yep.
Oh, nice. Oh, zero
tank,
health.
Lots of
another
airstrike.
Oh, if it pulls back there. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, but it went right on overhead here.
Yeah. Okay. So
two more tanks.
Yeah. One more tank. Yeah. Two more tanks.
It's fine.
It's poke damage regardless. Ah, here's the tech up for Murto. Finally, that's what I was waiting for.
Mm-hmm.
On a map this choky and this stalematey taking up is pretty much the only thing you can do to get an advantage.
Yeah.
Double orca production for Murto.
Oh wow.
Just has to be careful that it doesn't get outblocked by the light tanks of Andrew.
Yeah. Ooh. Oh, trying to push back, loses both of his rocket launchers, but this orca is doing the damage. So,
oh yeah, these orcas are going to
Apache is picking off two of the orcas.
Nice by Amphi.
Oh, three!
Nice move by Amphi here with the longbows.
And the chase.
Really did begin it.
Very effective.
Yep. A repair facility will also be a really smart investment this map.
Yeah, it's going to be so much damage with the airstrikes and the iron cannons.
Mm. Okay, in he goes, poking away at the longbows, killing one.
Ooh.
Oh, second one, taking some serious damage, not dying just yet.
No. Okay, and there is like 1 minute on the iron cannon.
Oh boy.
In 1 minute, with the press of a button, Murto can delete an entire blob.
Murto might want to try to do some fake attacks to try to gather up the army of Anju. Terms of gathering them for the iron cannon.
PP.
Pause, please.
Pause.
Yes.
Okay.
All right then.
Okay, sure. Pause.
So,
let's give him a break for a bit.
Okay.
So.
Actually, this gives me a good opportunity.
Mm-hmm.
Or wait, is it over already? Okay, retool.
Alright.
In the meantime,
are you in contact with Strelkov right now?
I have him on Steam.
Okay.
So
does he already know? Because he's right now on IRC. I could just type him.
He knows.
Alright.
Yeah,
in the meantime, let's just get Strelkov his game.
Indeed.
We can also pull up some stats here. What about Iku should be dead even. Yeah, bang even for everyone, pretty much. Amphi's a bit behind because he hasn't been harvesting his other patch. For a reason. Assets favoring Murto, unsurprisingly. Combat, Gatekeeper has been pretty aggressive, at least. Amphi's lost a lot.
Right.
The earnings graph is going to be so exciting here.
Inventory.
Yep. While you get to look at this amazing still here, we're going to get someone a game.
Sound good.
Send it to me.
And we have. Here he is. Next up.
There is one thing we haven't considered on this map, though.
Which is?
Those gates, considering that it's so hard to break through on this map. The Temple of Nod, you know how much health it has. You can't kill it even with two iron cannons.
Oh, really?
Yep. And so there's gonna be double nukes for Amphi and Anju. And there is pretty much nothing that Murto and Gatekeeper can do to prevent that from firing, because it has too much health. You can't just snipe it, and you can't kill it with the iron cannons either.
That's true. They're going to have to try to kill off the army.
Yeah, and opponents. A nuke, you know how devastating nukes can be. They can just kill the conyard, they can kill all the tech.
Yeah.
A nuke one-shots everything it touches, at least in the center of the explosion.
Yeah. Interestingly enough, that Andrew and Afi has no idea about the back base of Murto and Gatekeeper.
Mm-hmm.
Come on.
Yeah.
Yeah, Gorilla, I was just mentioning the Nod Temple. It's a big deal in the long run. I think this might come to, like, their faction pick might come to bite Murto and Gatekeeper in the ass. Because of how devastating nukes are. Compared to the Iron Cannon, which is a blob deleter, but not really much of a game ender.
Yeah. What they need to do is get the maybe a concerted attack against Anju.
Yeah, exactly. Use the iron cannon to kill the entire blob for Anju, and then move in with on one front unified with a blob of mediums. It's the only chance I see for them.
Yeah.
But they pick the faction and they pick them up, so
it's up to them. Yep.
Right, yep. He has accepted it. Enjoy your game, our Akron!
What game is this?
No, Gorilla, they haven't scouted it yet, and that's the problem. It's so hard to scout because there are SAM sites everywhere, and like, you don't want to waste your airstrike on scouting.
Ready!
Everyone ready? Amphi's ready?
Kravixen, thank you for the follow, I really do appreciate it!
And you, we haven't...
Ooh, Mammoth Tanks! And the game is paused once again.
Yeah, we have to need the word from Andrew. We can't just start a game without his does this consent. All right, there we go.
Ready.
He apologizes.
Ready now. It's a go. Oh, and
God.
Already costs a longbow. Costs a longbow here. Ooh, this is a pretty aggressive move here.
Look at this. Yeah, the
orcas.
I think
one of the orcas. What was he doing here?
Oh.
And by the way, the Allahu Akbar doesn't work in this mod.
No.
You've seen the plane crash right on top of the minigunners, and they took like what half their life and damage, half their health.
Yeah.
No problemo here.
It's quite a swarm that
the
GDI has here.
Yeah.
Ooh,
and there are mobile sams coming out of Effie.
That's
good choice. I can't even put explosion map on. Ooh. But those don't track too far. You can outrun them.
Alright. They're just going to go straight in for it. Or not.
Yeah.
Ooh, hits it.
Oh god.
What's the...
It's a nice
the mobile Sam is kind of off track.
Mobile Sam a bit slightly too much too forward. You know?
Yeah.
Just a tad bit. Wow, this is getting really sloppy. I think Murto has his Orca waypoints fucked up.
And 5 seconds.
The second Orca just donated.
5 seconds until the iron cannon is ready, so they might actually want to try to.
Yeah, I think
push
they
want to
go for an aggressive move here.
Yeah.
But it's so split up. Look at how defensively Andrew is placed here.
Yeah.
Real defense.
What's with the harvester? That harvester for a gatekeeper.
Oh.
Right on the orb edge of Amphi.
Oopsie.
Yeah.
Whoopsie. Because what they need to do is bundle all their two airstrikes and the advanced communication center. Because the nuke is gonna come up in like what 2 minutes?
Okay, airstrike.
It's gonna be a good airstrike here.
Should be.
Ooh, all the infantry.
Yeah, oh, that's too bad.
Gotta miss it.
Gonna make it.
Too late.
No, no, no. The machine gun's got some stuff.
Yeah, sure. That was actually pretty good.
Here's the Temple of God.
Not a very smart attack by these light tanks.
No.
But here comes the just Apache. No.
Okay. Did not the light tanks get poked out.
Ooh.
They're dead. Ooh, the APCs are so good mixed in here because they're anti-air.
Oh yeah.
They have pretty stellar damage versus longbows.
Another mobile Sam here. Two of them, in fact. So yeah. Let's see the
what a pokey match here.
Iron Cannon is ready, they just need to find a place to push it.
Hello, J-Man!
They're just looking for a target here.
Mm-hmm.
It's back and forth, it's like kiting into your defensive lines.
Yeah.
And
Amphi doesn't really have that much of an army.
Nope.
And
okay.
Okay, Gatekeeper's pushing now. This actually might be very nice for them.
Oh, that's a devastating airstrike.
Airstrike, ow! Yeah.
Ow!
Okay. Oh, maybe he can take down the side, then he should
what about,
back after that.
What about infantry?
And another airstrike!
He gets a lot of the infantry here. And another
nice
airstrike on the defenses, on the obelisk especially.
Okay.
The obelisk is done.
What about the iron
cannon? Oh god. That,
well,
look at Angie. Angie has so much.
They need to take down the
medical troopers coming in, though.
The obelisk cursed. I'm not liking Art of Fire's odds here. Look at the army from Anju. Look at his army.
Yeah.
Now they've wasted all their cooldowns.
Well, let's see though. We do have a bunch of orcas going to the flank Anju. Just have to be careful about the mammothine. If they can, keep their health, they should be very good there. Look at this. Look at these orca fires.
If you can keep mammoths alive. They're just going to regenerate up to 50%, which is a pretty big deal.
Murky the Ray is pulling back his injured tank, so we will do additional damage. But yeah, Andrew is looking dangerous with his infantry
block here, and there is everything is in a cooldown now.
Yeah,
there is no counter to the Chem Warriors, honestly. What do you do against the Chem Warriors here?
Orcas. I'm just joking. No, the rocket launcher is actually doing nice damage against them right now. So if this MLRS is going to... No, it's that three MLRS is going to do fine.
Okay, that's the only thing you can do, get crushes.
And then you have
thing
the...
You can actually
look
do versus
at,
this
look
army
at
composition
this.
Here.
Even Andrew's army is going to be crushed by these firing, so...
Yeah.
Or he's doing the suicide thing with the orcas now. Doesn't do damage at all.
Then like the orca suicides here. It's not like in Red Alert where you get all the bars off.
Nope.
Oh, it's a pretty big win for Angie, I'd say.
I hear a commando, I think.
Yeah.
Oh, here you go.
Yes,
well,
there is
the
a commando
has
now.
Been neutralized, and the nuke is going to come in a few seconds here. But yeah.
I think Chem Warriors are the way to go. Because what can you... Oh god, the nuke is coming up. What can you really do versus the Chem Warriors as GDI? Crutches is the only thing that comes to mind.
Yeah. Neither Andrew or Amphi can attack into the north, though. Just keep that in mind.
No.
I'm guessing that Dot has the flame tanks?
Yep.
Yes.
Yeah, okay, so that's something you've also...
No, you that's can't. Out of the question as well, yeah. Unfortunately.
Okay, the nuke is coming in.
Hey guys, we only have an hour before our second stream of the day starts.
Oh yeah.
This might be a long game, guys.
Yeah?
This might be a long game, though.
This was a long game already. Okay, the
eyes
are getting picked
off. The artillery.
All the artillery right there.
And if he gets the SAM sights, you know, the SAM sights are going to be a nice,
nice
thing to kill here. We're seeing our first stealth tank.
Yeah.
Okay.
Unaccounted for.
Yeah.
The orcas are scanning for it. He's on defensive duty here. You
can't
get past. There are no gaps in the defense here, I think. Or are there?
Let's see.
The detection radius of the turrets is so abysmal. Like 3 cells.
Oh, but it's right in there!
Alright.
And that was a waste.
That was
Look at the weapons.
Here comes
right
the
on top of
both
the advanced.
The advanced and the regular communication center.
Oh,
that
is
horrible.
Murder's moving.
Murtaugh's moving out of his MCV.
He thinks it's on the conyard, but it's not on the conyard. It's on the tank. This is horrible here.
Might also take out the barracks and the war factory, though.
Yeah, war factory not. Not the War Factory.
Oh, I thought the MCV of
both the Voitech.
Goodness gracious.
This is devastating. This is absolutely devastating here.
This is setting Mortal back
so
much.
The nuke can come back up. Nuke is gonna be back up in 3 minutes.
Yeah.
Or four.
This is gonna be setting so much back here.
3 minutes would be kind of OP.
Now, yeah. Now is the time to move in. Angie sees his chance. There
Andrew
is one
is
commando, but yeah, one commando.
They need all the ammunition for this infantry here.
Yeah.
Everything they can muster to stop this, because this might be damaging to this economy. Let's see.
This might already do some pretty good damage here.
There you go.
Oh, don't run in with the orcas.
Down.
No. You don't want to do this.
No,
it's such horrible trades here. Disgusting trades.
Yeah. Oh no, Murta the Ray.
Oh, Murta, no, not like this.
Air's
building up
coming
here
in.
Because
it's not against them.
You need something. I mean, the Humvees can be, but look at how fast they die.
There's a barracks again for Mortal.
Everything dies. There's a Visceroid. So we're seeing some Visceroid rage action. Two Visceroids.
Oh, here, right there.
Yeah.
And now Amphi's coming
actually
again.
Zoom in. There you go.
Art of fire on the backtrack. Neither Amphi or Gatekeeper has built the advanced tech here. So it's just this Temple of Nod for Anju that's going to be the decisive factor.
Anju the only one with the tech here.
Yeah.
Yep.
That's what I was afraid of, because the Temple of Nod, you can't snipe that. Possible. And Nod also has better stealth, scouting mechanisms with the stealth tanks.
Yeah. Oh wow. This game turned around quite quickly.
Massively. I still don't like the map choice. It would have been better to just pick a regular map.
Yeah.
All right. Selling guard towers, he needs the cash.
Yeah.
To cash start.
Desperate times.
So, now let's pull up the combat tab again. You see that Murta has lost a lot more than he has killed. And Angie has done a fantastic job holding it down here.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
See the earnings still even. And assets, looking in team Eva's favor here.
Yeah. Absolutely.
We're not gonna get much of a break, because this game is far from being over, by the way.
Yeah, by the looks of things, yeah.
So many mobile SAMs moving out here. Amp is just trying to keep the orc account low.
Advanced communication center is back up for Murto. I'd love to see Gatekeeper do the same. There's no reason not to build the Iron Cannon at this point. He's actually... I mean, he could just build one earlier, and then we'll be... It would be in a better position. Now we'll see the Hand of Nod by Amphi though. That's
a lot better.
About.
One Apache for one Orca.
Yeah.
There's so much anti-air going on here at Amphi's base.
Yeah. Oh.
Ah, and he's just kiting into this.
Oh. Yeah, and you might lose both of these rocket launchers. Oh, ouch.
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 Ouch. Triple. Horrible, do not want.
No!
Another one.
So bad. Okay, medium tank push into this. There's a couple
Finally
of
enough, they're on ground defenses here for Amphi.
Yeah, a couple of light tanks here.
He's gonna get the harvester at least.
That's
gonna delay the
another
a bit.
Commando, I hear.
Yeah.
Yep, that's back at Murta's base. Murta's just playing defensively.
Yeah, he has
defense,
no choice.
Defense.
He has
oh,
no
nice,
choice.
Look at this. Amphi, okay, here comes the chem troopers, so they're coming.
Yeah, the chem troopers come in and they're gonna clean house.
Yeah.
Unless they get crushed.
Oh, Emily Rest should fire upon them. Yeah, they will.
Yeah, but look at the pathetic damage.
Yeah, but they
just
keep it up.
Cutting it.
No.
Now the longbows have taken out the MRLS.
Such a dogfight is this.
Yeah.
Oh,
what a scrappy match here.
No, the MLRS is just going to keep coming back here and try to siege the base. Which I should. Ooh! Amphi is actually low powered right now.
Pulling a doobie.
Yep.
Ooh.
Yeah, because he built the temple and not.
At long last.
Yeah.
Double nukes going up.
Oh wow, yeah, that's why it's low powered.
Yep. There is no anti-air here, so this no, okay, there is an APC, never mind.
Yeah.
Plonk.
There goes the logo.
Oh, airstrike.
Ooh.
Good night, Prince. And another airstrike going on to another, that was the airstrike, sorry.
Yeah.
Commando taking out the airstrip.
What?
It got sold. It got sold. Okay. So he gets the cash back, 1k.
Airstrip. Okay. Might as well at this point.
Then I missed that.
Yeah. So
that was an interesting play here. Uh-huh. But it's only one of the two airstrips of Amphi.
This map is slowly getting the void of Tiberium.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's been that for a while.
Airstrike coming in.
Oh, not doing it. Yeah, okay.
Trying to go for the Ken troopers.
Mobile Sam.
Not succeeding.
Yeah. Still two though in the main base of Amphi.
But again, Anju has such a big army. The nuke is in 20 seconds.
Yeah. Okay, so they just keep building in tanks, and if Amphi for some reason doesn't take counter, they just have the chemical warriors of Anju. They could just dart in here and snipe the tech structures if they're fast enough.
Oh, that airstrike was not good.
Here comes another airstrike.
At least they spotted the temple. Damn, rock and roll. What a waste of an airstrike.
Yeah, could have been more useful on the head of Dot up there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Would have sniped so many infantry.
Okay, Gatekeeper moving in again, sniping harvesters, I guess, if he gets them.
This should get them both.
Yep.
Yeah.
Just harvested out.
Setting in the APCs against the Apache.
Oh, nice.
Nice. The Apache down.
Yep.
Oh, and both some sites are in danger. Some mobile sites.
Ooh, Iron Cannon on Angie's army. Getting a lot of value there.
Okay, nice. I needed that.
As we're stuck mid animation.
Yep. Beautiful.
But the nuke is coming.
There was like 5 light tanks and a massive amount of chem warriors.
Luke?
Ooh. Nuke should be coming any second now.
Mm-hmm.
And Anju does not know. Well, he knows about the communications center, so I'm
curious.
But
he hasn't scouted the advance this time around.
Yeah.
So tech snipe is not going to be as devastating as it was previously.
Yeah. Let's see though.
Apache's taking a lot of poke again. Stealth tank. Yeah. He's doing the same trick again. He's just suiciding a stealth tank in here.
One stealth tank. For the tech snipe.
One stealth and two stealth and three stealth and two.
It's got spotted. It should find the communication center here.
Yes.
Well, let's see. Oh, yeah, found it!
He found it! He did find it.
Yeah,
and
now...
And he got a harvester. Oh, God.
And then comes Nuke. Yeah, Gatekeeper, he needs... There's Nuke in Colombia.
Yeah, right on the advanced comm center.
Yeah.
Yeah. Move your ship out of the way here.
Well, Gatekeeper's in the... In the west over here, going after a Visceroid.
Yeah.
Hunting Visceroids. Visceroid Rage.
I'm hunting Visceroids!
There we go.
Oh, okay. Oh well.
Just the advanced
concept. The stealth tank is still just in the middle of the base. Look at the vision it provides. scrappy match here.
Yeah, trying to take out that
okay, now there's
well.
An advanced guard tower.
Yeah. Oh. Okay.
Stealth
now
tank is not gonna make
now.
It.
Airstrike.
Oh, the airstrike on Gatekeeper.
Oh,
that's a lot of damage.
That hurts.
I'm having a feeling that the prize fighters will be the prize fighters.
Yeah. Look, it's just exactly what I predicted is happening. The two nukes, you can't stop those, and they're gonna constantly snipe your tech and more and more and more, and eventually gonna crumble.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Yeah, the other nuke is more than halfway done already. Mm-hmm. Got a massive blob moving in from Anju over here.
And all the airstrikes. Airstrikes are like 3/4 through.
Alright.
Still far from coming up though.
Gatekeeper might get a good one.
It's a bit boring. It's a bit boring. Are you serious? It's madness, man.
It's complete madness.
It is, It's slow right now.
Given that, you know, the slow eco is a problem.
Ooh.
light tanks sniping down the orcas.
Stealth tanks sniping here. The orcas. I think it's not gonna last much longer. Maybe two more nukes and then the game's gonna be over.
I don't like this attack by Andrew, actually.
No.
It's he's just giving the northern team a chance to come back with this.
Yeah. Okay,
airstrike down.
Could be good though.
Let's see, will they try for some squishes? Yeah, they will.
Mm-hmm.
Fresh.
Yeah. Crushes have to be good here.
Yeah.
Oh, there are some good crushes.
Yeah.
Yeah, the attack is
losing too much.
Angie losing a lot, but thing is, it still burns so much material that you can't just go and counterattack after this. Alright, and still a couple cams up. Kemmer is just so strong. Like, look at the DPS they put out. It's insane.
But,
Yeah, the high-end Nod units are pretty fucking devastating. Stealth tanks are pure glass cannons, but they do so much damage.
Yes. Here comes the push, though.
More Chem Warriors. Is Gate coming with a push here?
Don't think so. I don't think he wants. Three more stealth tanks looking for the orcas. Looking for some juicy air snipes. Maybe a tech snipe. Maybe the comm center.
Advanced comm center is back though. Pretty much the exact same spot.
Oh wow, yeah, this stealth tanks, this is actually a threat to the communication center. No doubt.
Yeah, they can three shot it.
Yeah, and just scouting for now. To places.
Yeah, he found the advanced comm again. He found the other comm of Gatekeeper.
Yep.
Ooh! This airstrike is not going to do much.
Mertz's airstrike completely whiffing. Ouch. He was expecting the cams to come in.
Whoops.
Another airstrike over here.
That did do some damage.
The
airstrike of Gate was better.
Yeah, but it's not going to do anything.
Not doing much here. And he's losing so many orcas to the SAM side.
Yeah. Oh, look at the stealth tanks to the top left there.
Yeah, going after the eco. There's the advanced guard tower from Gate. Very defensive.
Yeah.
Very defensive.
Outside of the range.
So the stealth tanks are defensively backed into a corner here. Out of detection range. Damn it.
Yep.
It's obnoxious. Settling them immediately.
Ooh, the MLRS is getting picked off. It's really bad.
APC out of position here.
Avon launched.
Looking for the stealth tank.
Yeah.
Avon coming in on
and
the...
And here comes the nuke.
Yep.
Right at the advanced comm center.
Again.
Yeah, again, resetting Mertz's tank. And it's also going to get Gates Harvester.
Yeah.
Don't know if it's going to kill it. That's pretty much up to chance. Pretty dead.
Yep.
Pretty dead, if you ask me. And by the way, nukes kill Tiberium. Did you see it kill off the Tiberium?
Yep.
So it sets the eco back a bit too. Stealth tank getting another pick on the power plant.
Oh wow.
Next nuke in 40 seconds?
Yeah.
I feel like this game is gonna slowly get lost to the faction picks. Because double GDI on a choky map, you can't break through. Just not happening.
Yeah. Yeah, they're going to have a lot of lucky streaks in order to come back on this.
You gotta have to say though, it was also really unlucky from Team Art of Fire that they lost all the important coin tosses. Every single important coin toss went towards Anju. Like, he's gotten four Tiberian Dawn games.
Uh-huh. Match of the series.
Wow.
Airstrike coming in.
Airstrike. Doing all the damage.
Yeah.
This is
the last match of the semi-finals, and after this we still have the finals to do, which will start in less than 45 minutes.
We won't have time for dinner. We're gonna
have to eat dinner during the stream though, because I'm not gonna wait until the finals are over, which could also result in this long of a thing.
It's been 25 minutes, but the problem is there have been some lag spikes and it's overall just a bit choppy. So the actual timer is well over 30 minutes now.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, nuke coming up in like 15. After that, I don't know what's gonna happen.
Well, it seems that Gatekeeper is selling out a bunch of stuff. He's like probably really low on money.
Yeah, he's broke. Yeah, it's broke.
Everyone is pretty broke for that matter.
Here's the commando.
Yeah.
Being scouted by the stealth tanks. Turret coming up immediately.
Yeah, imagine
they have to make a desperation play at this point.
Imagine the difference if Gatekeeper actually had an advanced communication center. It's the same as Marco. It's like, I don't understand.
They could have done so much more there.
Yeah.
There we go.
Now the commando is running headfirst into Chem Warriors, just gonna say hi.
Uh-huh.
Hi there.
Oh!
Orcs are getting picked off to boot. Kirillus had a good point in chat. Angie also won the important coin tosses versus Team Spirillo.
Yep.
So Angie has been like the luck of the draw.
Wow.
Has been
conspiracy.
Yeah, conspiracy.
Conspiracy. Morto now having an advanced comp sensor all the way in the back of Andrew's or Gate's base.
Yeah.
But it'll get
there. There's a
up.
Stealth tank in again.
Yeah.
Finally! Oh no, never mind. What? Morto has double the advanced communication centers. I just feel like, come on, Gatekeeper, just get one of them.
That is a waste
yeah.
of cash.
Yeah.
The double advance?
Yep.
Okay, well, then nuke is actually going to be a waste. If Merkin somehow figured this out and pulled back his harvester,
he sold it.
The nuke is.
Wow.
Yeah, it's going to be a waste.
Oh, it's going to be nice. Merkin is pulling away with his harvesters as well.
Mm-hmm. It's going to kill an engineer. An engineer and 3x from that, and that's it.
Yeah. Nice.
There it goes.
Nice move by Merkin.
Very nice
save there. And the ion cannon is still going up here for Muto.
Yeah.
Well, you guys say it's a waste of money. I say it's very well played.
No, yeah, I don't say it's a waste of money.
It was just a really good play by Murto.
And yeah, now we just need to see that.
Because he wants to retain his tech and he needs to.
Yeah.
He needs to see that by a Gatekeeper. If they're going to have a chance, they need the Iron Cannon for both players. So I'm kind of bothered by this.
But Mal is right. They should stop nuking the tech and go for the call yards.
The thing is, the Quaniards can move up out of the way. He should nuke the army, if you ask me. Because no one's gonna expect the nuke on the army.
Yeah. Good point. Orcas is trying to kill off Chem Warriors now.
Trying to kill Chem Warriors. Good one.
Hashtag try.
Well, well, at least we tried.
Yes.
Yeah. Jesus.
So in TD there is no mechanism like a chronosphere or a iron curtain to break through.
No.
Nope.
Sadly though.
There is a nice juicy target of 8, soon to be 9 light tanks. Right over there.
But look at all the infantry. I feel like Team Anju can push this down very shortly. It's not gonna take much longer.
Yeah. They're getting the army ready.
Hmm.
God, look at this desperation move here.
Hmm.
Top, yeah. Just like 40.
That's
Iron Cannon.
Yeah, see? Who Iron Cannons you needed for that one?
Mm hmm.
That shit OP!
Yeah. Well, nah, this.
I think I think that this is the moment where they decide, like, this is useless.
Hmm.
Yeah, double airstrikes and a Iron Cannon didn't kill it. That's pretty rough.
That's exactly what I was telling about. You can use all your support powers in one temple, it's not even gonna kill it.
Nope.
It's so stupid. And on the other hand, the advanced communication center just gets sniped by a single nuke.
Uh-huh. Someone entered the
room. Okay, let's get him out. IK.
Who's Vietnam?
Viet Man is fucking spy. But about the IK guy, I don't know.
I already kicked him.
Never seen him before.
Huh.
Now they are in a room with fucking Spy.
Yeah, great. Spy's defense, so no problem. Nuke
weapon launched. Oh, the car, you're on this side.
The
Moving out of the way.
Moving away. So it's gonna be fine. But look at this army.
But this is the game ender. This is it.
Second MCV?
No. You can get two MCVs in one swift nuke. Okay.
They're moving out.
Yeah,
but it could
fine.
Get the power. Yep, power down.
Wow.
Here comes the Dilby.
But I have to ask you, is it pulling a Doomy if you actually get if your opponent knocks you into low power, is that a Doomy as well?
Okay, this is the this
everything
is the
that involves you
here.
Having power problems is pulling a Doomy.
Okay. Look at all these medium tanks, they're going to have to look at this.
This is the final push. I think that this would be a final push.
And imagine, if Murto and Gatekeeper had their airstrikes here with the iron cannon, this would be a different thing.
Mm-hmm. That's why Angie was waiting. He knew he could push into double iron
cannons.
Murto
is killing off his stuff as well. Okay, this push to the top here by Angie, the small group might actually just take out the advanced communication center here.
Yeah.
Yep.
Just going to
pulling
be,
a Dilby also
might just take
involves,
out everything, if you ask me.
Yeah, pulling a Dilby also involves having no radar or getting lost in an adventure game.
Getting lost in an adventure game.
Yeah.
Oh, nice crushes there.
When I was playing Overlord, and Overlord Raging Hell, I just got lost. Uh-huh. I didn't know where the hell I was supposed to go. I was just wandering around aimlessly for a whole bunch of minutes.
Yeah.
The second attack by Amphi here. Probably just gonna seal the deal.
That's the power.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Got to take the power back.
Here you go.
There is nothing left for Murto. Almost barely anything left for Gatekeeper.
Uh-huh.
We're gonna see him call quits here. They know when they've lost.
Yeah, especially with this.
Like, I feel it's been a very fair matchup. And they tried some really nice stuff early game. Come on. So rude.
Yeah. Alright, don't want to lose that weapon factory if they want to keep playing, and they don't lose.
Yo, leave him the time. Let him time to play.
Yeah.
Yeah, we can't push them. But
there is the snipe with the stealth tanks. Very
nice.
Right
there. There it is. Barf and Friend Limiter are already ready.
Mm-hmm. Chumpo's eating some chocolate right now. Get my energy up. I will just leave the stream running.
Yeah, me too. So we're all fucked.
Trivial. The art of fire won't be forgotten. Yeah. Doomhammer twisting the knife there. With some salt.
If at first you don't succeed, twist the knife a little deeper. That's the wisdom of an ancient evil guy.
Nuclear weapon launched. Hmm.
Alright.
Here comes the other nuke on the comm center and the construction yard.
Yeah.
Merchant just got his advanced comm up again.
Over there.
But yeah, they're just being nuked back into the Stone Age here.
Poor guys.
And?
Luckily, Murto has a second conyard.
Build two.
There you go.
This is just so desperate here. Nothing to do anymore.
Yeah.
There is an airstrike for Gatekeeper ready.
Well,
this airstrike will be good.
Andrew coming in once again.
Yeah.
Yep.
Billing.
Butts of Afghan troopers.
He was repairing his conyard with engineers here. March what that is. Bless you.
Yeah.
Yeah, March has Two conyards, one barracks, one power plant, one refinery left.
And that's it.
That's it for Murto.
No units to defend with whatsoever.
Yeah.
Nope. Gate's weapon factor is not gonna change that anytime soon.
Nope.
Look at all the Viscerites that have spawned here.
Pretty bad.
One conyard down.
Yep.
Low power for Murto. Oh, not even though. Excuse me, he has another power plant somewhere.
Yeah, where? Still left in gate keeper space.
Yeah, the first one. He also still has. Murto calls the GG.
He's calling GG.
GG.
Mm-hmm.
And with that, surprisingly, the prize fighters.
That was a really surprising victory here.
Yeah.
The prize fighters.
Prizemasters take it. I did not see this. I mean, I saw it coming like in the TD match now, but I wouldn't have seen this coming like half an hour earlier.
Indeed.
No. That can happen. We had a lot of boom down games here for Andrew.
He just had the luck of the draw, man.
Sure did.
So many. Well, just so many TPD games for him.
Death or glory?
Death or glory! Or lag.
Alright.
Peace through low power!
So, with that, I have turned on my oven and go to make my dinner real quick. And, yeah.
Good call.
Yeah.
I'm just going to mute the stream for like 30 minutes. Have a break for all the participants because it's going to be really exhausting for them.
Yeah. That's why we announced a break in between the streams anyway.
Yeah.
Have something to eat for ourselves because it is dinner time, or actually way past dinner time for me already.
Yes. So yeah, see you guys in half an hour.
See ya.
Honestly, half an hour. Now that Murto is dead, he should probably just go out of the game because I think he's the one lagging. I'm afraid.
Well, we're all being dropped at 37 seconds.
Oh no, what shall we do?
And Murto has disconnected. Here we go.
Should be a bit smoother now.
Weapon factory is down. Number one still has one left. Whole bunch of harvesters.
It's not Myrtle then. Must be Andrew. I mean, he's from Australia after all.
Australia?
Australia!
Australia!
He's from Australia, mate.
Aye. Shrimp right, Adabi.
Right, let's go to the beach.
Shrimp Adabi. Duke is almost ready for.
Fuck this shit.
For Elfie, though.
Uh-huh.
That will be the deciding factor. Nope! Gets the knight!
I'm gonna play World of Tanks, then.
Alrighty.
So with that out of the way, we are actually having an upset victory. I did not see that coming.
Me neither.
Wow. Prize fighters are having a 5-3, and they're gonna advance into the finals.
Indeed.
As you guys can already see on brackets here.
Oh.
So the finals are gonna be the Amholz versus the Prize Fighters.